story is, I said with my heart that I'm picking Vancouver, and I want Vancouver to win. Pat Quinney's my old defense partner, but at the start, Tom, I'll tell you over there that I picked New York. I cannot believe they can come in here and beat New York again, but it boils down to two things that I'm going to say. Terry Gregson, if he doesn't call a billion penalties, we'll be all right. Comes down to McLean and Richter. Whoever's hot, that's going to win, because I think the teams are awash now. It's the two hot goalies. Which one's going to win?
It's going to be New York.
I'm saying New York will win 5-3 in an open net.
If Messier can answer that call tonight and pull the Rangers to victory, then it's legend. I'm not so sure he's got it in him. I think this group, with all their character, may just have gone one step too many into a long, hot summer, and I think the Canucks might jump on them. And if they ever get him down, they might win it going away.
I think they're going to win. We're going to get this
curse business out of the way. I think it's ludicrous. It's ridiculous. They just haven't been able to win for any of a number of reasons, but this curse business is silly. It's going to end tonight.
Score?
Empty net goal,
4-2.
Two votes for the Rangers, one for Vancouver there. Oh, yes, and speaking of international predictions, Nigerian Hakeem Olajuwon involved in this exchange at the Houston Rockets practice yesterday.
Care at all who wins here tomorrow night on the ice?
Yes, of course.
Who do you like?
Oh, the
hockey.
You can change. I like Vancouver.
Ooh.
Anything against New York.
There is another title series going on in New York this week, but tonight should be one of the biggest games in the history of New York City sports. Enjoy it. It's next on MSG.
U.S. Healthcare. Sometimes the best medicine of all is a good laugh.
These in my ears, I can't hear. Look, here, try it yourself now. See that? Can you hear anything? What? Can you hear me? Huh? You can't hear anything, can you? How can I hear if you're going to put these in my ears like that? I mean, after all, I can't hear if you got them in my ears.
Huh? Hold me closer. Closer. Closer.
I hold you any closer, I'll be in back of you.
This gift is from Jackie, O'Golly O'Shucks. I hope that you like it. It costs $40.
All other husbands have their wives behind them. Napoleon had Josephine behind him. George Washington had Martha behind him. Mark Antony had Cleopatra behind him. What have I got behind me? Don't you dare!
U.S. Healthcare, a health plan for living.
For moments when there's no time to waste, Cellular One and Nobody Beats the Wiz put you in touch automatically in over 300 cities across North America.
Hello.
Boomer!
It's 3rd and 17, Joe. I need some help.
Where's the ball? 76 dig, X corner.
Cellular One and Nobody Beats the Wiz. Cellular service.
Hello.
You need to use a pitching wedge.
That's
there.
Simply the best.
The next time you really want to feel the difference a gasoline can make in your car's performance, go Gulf. Because the fact is, Gulf's super unleaded gasoline helps give your car more acceleration, more performance, and helps clean your car's engine better than ever before. Try a tank full today.
Some things just get better all the time.
What do you need to be the best?
Starter.
Every time I go out there,
the adrenaline starts pumping.
Chills running down my spine.
I'm scared.
Whoa. Talent can only take you so
motivated yourself.
You gotta have something inside.
A burning desire to go out there and compete every night.
You need to do everything it takes.
Stopping at nothing.
I'm not gonna stop.
Starter.
What do you need to be the best?
Everything you got. It's up to you.
Starter is proud to be the official locker room hat and t-shirt of the NHL Stanley Cup champions.
Can you imagine how exciting it would be to win in New York City for those players?
Ladies and gentlemen, the 1993-94 New York Rangers! Harper goes towards Belfour. He scores! That shot by Richter is a save. The rebound, another save. It's a showtime for Mike Richter. And here comes Kovalov.
There to play toward the net, blocked in front. Graves turns, he scores. Adam Graves. Now the celebration begins. 51 goals for Adam Graves.
There's nothing like the feeling of when the season's over with and you're able to drink champagne from the cup and the feeling of we are the best. And I think that's what drives me right now, is that feeling, to get that feeling again.
Robson for Kovalev, left circle, snapshot, save, rebound, score!
Professional sports is about pressure. It is about winning. We can't change that. So why not take that and use it to our advantage?
The New York Rangers will bring home the Stanley Cup. The Vancouver Canucks and the New York Rangers play one game for the Stanley Cup Championship. Good evening, everyone, and welcome to New York Rangers playoff hockey. Sam Rosen along with John Davidson, Al Trotwig, and Emil Francis. And this is what it's come down to, perhaps the greatest night of sports history here in New York.
You just can't help but sit back and enjoy this. This has been two teams that have gone at it. And I know that one team will win, one team will lose, but overall, hockey's become a winner with what we've seen throughout the playoffs. It's been a fabulous series, and I think we'll see another fabulous game right here.
The New York Rangers trying to end the 54-year drought will depend on their aces, Brian Leetch and Mark Messier.
Well, you see the numbers when they win, you see the numbers when they don't win, and that tells you how important it is for these two players to have a strong game here in Madison Square Garden this morning. There's always a huddle after the team has its game day skate. Once the huddle was over, look who Mike Keenan calls over and talks to. The captain, Mark Messier. Mark Messier is the undisputed leader on this hockey club. He then went over, and as you see, he puts a tap on Brian Leetch. He knows that Brian Leetch, if he's going, he'll be one of the leaders on the ice in this game. And, of course, Craig McTavish, who's been there, who has leadership skills also. This is a team, Sam, that would like a good start. They haven't scored a goal in the first period of the last three games. The last four games, Vancouver has scored the first goal in every game. The Rangers would like to jumpstart themselves, get it going early, and let the avalanche of support in this building carry them along.
But the Canucks know they can win in New York. They've won two of the three games here already, and their top offensive weapons have been Bure, Courtnall, and Brown.
This team has scored 10 goals in the last two games. And if you look at the numbers, 9 of the 10 goals have been scored by those three players. Bure has 19 shots on goal in the last three games. This team is rolling. They're very confident. It's up to the Rangers to work the Canucks deep in the Vancouver zone. That's been their game all season long. When the Rangers play pressure hockey, they win. They haven't done it the last couple of games, and it's up to them now to turn it around. This is a team that said yesterday when Mike Keenan met with them as their coach, to say he's their coach, while all this Detroit rumor was flying around, the players have told me that that was the best meeting they've had with their coaching staff all season long. Let's see what happens.
The building was shaking for Game 5. The Rangers did not deliver. It's shaking again right now. And this crowd hopes to shake the Vancouver Canucks' confidence.
Well, they're going to try, but Vancouver has a chance to set a team record for road wins. They've had 8 already on the season in the playoffs. It's a good road team. The Rangers can't be outworked. This will be a battle. There's key players on every team. Mike Keenan was asked, which player do you really want to watch on their team? He said, it's one game. You watch them all.
The New York Rangers coming out onto the ice for Game 7 and their try to win the Stanley Cup. We'll be set to go in just a moment.
Oh, bored. Let's count the palm trees again. Why are you looking at me like that, Iggy?
You okay?
Cut it out. You're weirding me, man. stop looking at me like that, would you? You're creeping me out. Cut that out, man.
For the great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light.
Iggy, you're gonna twist my head off. Iggy.
In business, there never seems to be enough of it. And the last thing you can afford to do is run out of it. Time. So rest assured, Delta Airlines will help you make the most of it. With over 4,900 flights a day to over 300 cities around the world. And best of all, we'll make sure you arrive relaxed and refreshed with plenty of time to spare. Delta Airlines.
New York Rangers hockey is brought to you by Budweiser. Fresh, pure, natural, proud to be your bud. By MetLife. Get met, it pays. By the card, the American Express card. Don't leave home without it. And by Delta Airlines, official airline of Madison Square Garden.
This is the 10th time in NHL history that a Stanley Cup final has gone to seven games. The home team has won seven. The away team has won two. The last time it went to seven games was 1987 when the Edmonton Oilers blew a 3-1 lead in the series and won game seven over the Philadelphia Flyers. One lineup change for the Rangers tonight. Joey Koser cannot go. He's got a leg injury. Nick Kiprios will replace him in the lineup. He's played a couple of games earlier in the playoffs against the Islanders when Koser was injured. The chant of "We want the cup" going up from the crowd here at Madison Square Garden. We are set for the Canadian and American national anthems.
Thank you.
it. Maybe he's able to tune it out, John.
All goaltenders try to. You just try to get focused. It looks like he is. If you see him concentrate and prepare. As we've said many times in this series, the only time he ever gets upset about anything is when he plays a bad game of golf.
Mike Richter, ready to go. Each goaltender has played every game for their respective team, trying to win number 16 and the championship game. Terry Gregson is the referee tonight. This is his 12th playoff game. It is the second, seventh game he's had. He had game seven, San Jose and Toronto in round number two. And it is the third game he has had in this series. The Rangers are 3-1 in games he's officiated. Vancouver is 2-1.
And remember this, Vancouver has scored first in four consecutive games, the last four games in this series. The Rangers have not scored a first period goal in their last three games. Remember, the last time they were here, they had one nullified on the offside call that should have been allowed. However, it's a one-game shot. The fans are standing already. Oh, wow. Already, everybody wants it. Let's watch Mark Messier's first shift.
Messier, Graves, Anderson, Leach, Kimbukabong for the Rangers. McIntyre, Antoski, Hunter, Hedekin, and Brown. Shot fake by Anderson. Takes the shot, deflected, stopped by McClain, clears it aside. Anderson swings it around, pass Messier, Antoski and Bukabum go for it and collide. The puck out of the zone to Leach. Leach lifts back in. Brown drives it around the boards. Picked up by Antoski. Antoski for McIntyre. It was deflected. Bukabum reaches out to get it. Bukabum fires ahead, intended for Graves, all the way down. Comes to McClain. He plays it away for Messier. Up the board, Steve Larmer has come on for the Rangers with Stefan Matteau.
And right away, Vancouver puts Murray Craven with Pavel Bure. He wants to feed Bure as much as possible.
Richter with a quick shot testing him. Kovalov has come on with Larmer and Matteau. Low and Zubov moved down to the zone, sent back in by Dave Babich. Babich on with Gerald Dittick. Craven, Bure, and Adams on for Vancouver. The rolling puck into the corner. Larmer is there. Checked by Babich. Battle in front as Matteau is battling with Dittick. Lowe is in deep against Murray Craven. Puck along the board. Zuboff in deep to get it. His pass intercepted by Adams. Out comes Bure. Bure on the rush, 3-on-2. He goes down. The pass by Dittick is blocked. Bure gets it. It's an offside whistle.
Bad play by Zuboff as things heat up immediately. Zubov pinched nicely, got control of the puck, but when he threw a blind pass, it trapped all the Rangers and gave Vancouver a 3-on-2. There comes Zubov. Look at this bad pass. He's hit. Everybody's trapped deep, and Vancouver has a 3-on-2, and Pavel Bure is forced right there and put offside. Nice play by Alexei Kovalov to stop Vancouver's 3-on-2. Look at Kovalov standing up. Boom! And Bure's offside, and the Rangers get a break. You can't throw the puck blind when you're pinching. You're one of the last players, and Zubov can't do that.
Nemchinov on with Gilbert and Kiprios, Wells and Lidstrom, Trevor Linden with Nathan Lafayette, and Jeff Cortinall, defense pairing of Ryan Glynn and Jurke Lume. Lume has the puck. Deflection of the Vancouver bench. We've played a minute, 48 seconds of game seven. There is Alexei Kovalov, who made the play on Bure, forcing the offside. Rangers line up with one change. Nick Kiprios is in. Joey Koser is out. Defense pairing. Doug Lidstrom remains in the lineup. And of course, Mike Richter starting in goal with Glenn Healy as the backup for Mike Keenan. His fourth Stanley Cup final, looking for his first Stanley Cup championship.
He wants his team to forecheck more, do what they call cycling. In other words, turning like a bicycle cycle in the corner. Two or three players to catch Vancouver napping a little bit. And if you get caught deep, interfere with the Vancouver's defensemen so they can't head back up ice offensively.
Thinking and battling in the corner against Lume. McTavish is in. Noonan is in for the puck. He takes a hit from Glynn. Cliff Ronning has it. It's Ronning with Momesso and Jelena. Ryan Glynn moves the puck off the glass. Knocked down by Lidstrom. Sends it back into the Vancouver zone. McClain leaves it for Lume. Forechecking is Tikkanen. Off his stick. Up the boards, McTavish gets it to Tikkanen. Try to put it in front of his block. Noonan looking for it. Up the boards comes Martin Gelinas. He slowed down.
Vancouver with too many men for a moment, but the defenseman got on. Rangers are forechecking, but not getting anything out of it yet.
Up in the Rangers zone, taken away by Brian Noonan. Taken and comes out with Jay Wells in the middle. Messier has just come on. Save made by McClain. Knocks it into the corner. Brown chops at it. Bounces down in center ice, and Glenn Anderson handles it. Anderson sends back in. Messier for the puck against Hedekin. Messier trying to come out in front. Back pass intended for Graves was wide of the mark and out of the zone.
No fooling around with the Rangers. They're dumping the puck all the time. Not getting caught in the neutral zone. Trying to dump as much as possible and work Vancouver's defenseman.
Linden fell down, gets the pass ahead. It's off the stick of Courtnall, and Bukaboom takes over. Messier finished the check on Linden. Graves gets to the puck. Graves lifts it clear. Nathan Lafayette has it back. Gave it up to Jeff Bukaboom. 3.5 minutes gone by in the first period. Again, the fans roar at what looked like too many men on the ice. Tipped away and out of the zone. Dittick battling for the puck. Messier's got it. Feeds Larmer. Knocked away from him. Leach picks it up. Rangers with two shots on goal. Canucks with one. Bukaboom holds back. Goes to Larmer. Kovalov has come on with Mantel and Larmer. Larmer was knocked down. And the whistle stops play for faceoff in the Rangers zone. 16:08 to go. First period, game seven. We'll be right back.
Driver, do you have any Bud Light in your vehicle?
Yes.
And I am Mr. Galiwikich.
You mean Dr. Galakowicz?
Yes, I am. This is so cool!
First time in a limo, Doctor?
In a limo this small.
If you want great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light.
Hello, Linus. I see your blanket's out for washing.
I feel so insecure.
Security is why over 45 million people trust MetLife to ensure their lives and health and help plan their retirement.
Does MetLife give out blankets?
No, but the world-famous MetLife representative is the very symbol of security in an uncertain world.
You're right. I feel better already.
Get Met. It pays.
You're not supposed to have six skaters on the ice, and if you count them from right to left, there's six out there. Plus the goaltender, seven. There's no doubt Vancouver has made two sloppy changes, and on that one, in my opinion, they definitely got away with too many men.
Kevin Collins and Ray Scapinello are the linesmen for tonight's game. Messier back on with Graves and Anderson. Messier will go against Murray Craven. Craven on with Adams and Bure. Puck sent toward the net, but blocked. Graven trying to find it. Leach tied him up. Messier's got it.
Graven has had Vancouver's only shot on goal. You'd rather have him shoot the puck than Bure. His job, though, is when he gets the puck, he'll try to pass it to Bure as quickly as possible.
Bure hounded by Leach in deep. Graves moves it around, and Messier chases. Bumps with Babbage. Graven and Graves are in after the puck. Bure flies it loose. It ahead for Adams. Adams looking for Dittick, plays it down the boards into the corner. Dittick against Leach. Leach takes it. Graves comes in to help out. Up for Messier. Past Anderson, and Brian Glynn has the puck. Careful start thus far, John.
Body the Rangers tried to forecheck early, got nothing out of it. Vancouver has gotten through that first squall. Now it's their turn to try and get smart. Now both teams, it appears, have to play a bright game defensively, not give up anything.
Offside was whistled against Vancouver. Almost 5 minutes in. 4:52 gone by. As you look at Brian Glynn, boy, has he come a long way. A man picked up on waivers from Ottawa and got a chance to play when Dana Merson got hurt early in the playoffs, and he's taken advantage of it.
Well, Vancouver yesterday, actually Sunday, had 14 players go into that hyperbaric chamber. They went in 1 hour and 15 minutes apiece to inhale the pure oxygen. They have two machines in Vancouver, one at the University of British Columbia and the other in the Canuck dressing room. So they took advantage of that during the 2 days off prior to this game.
Thinking in knocked away by Lume. Ronning avoids the hit of McTavish. Richter leaves the puck to Doug Lidstrom. Mavesso is after him. Lidstrom moves it around the boards. Taking it. Lifts it clear. It's knocked down by Lume. Cliff Ronning has it and sends it back in.
Well, for two or three shifts now, Vancouver has controlled the neutral zone, and they too are dumping the puck in a lot.
Jeff Brown
is another example of it. Neutral zone is where Brown got the puck, and he dumped it in deep.
Rangers have not scored a first period goal in the last three games. Dangerous play, saved by Richter, and it's knocked loose. Noonan's got it. It bounced down, and they got a shot on Richter, and he made the stop. Brown back to the puck. And you can almost hear the nerves, the nervous reaction from the fans coming up. A couple of good hits by the Rangers. One by Nemchinov. The puck all the way down. This will be an icing. Low for the touch. Fans like it.
Greg Gilbert did a nice job stopping Big Tim Hunter from hitting Kevin Lowe as he got to the puck first for the icing. Seeing lots of hitting, very few scoring chances.
In 1930, we introduced the first pop-up toaster. Sometimes the unusual gift of today becomes the household item of tomorrow. Sometimes. When we say something is the best, it's because it's been tested and proven to be the best. I think it's for you. We have things here you won't find anywhere else. This hat has a built-in fan. No, really.
Since 1848, the first, the best, the only Hamaker Schlemmer.
Star Trek phone. Beam me up.
Starts Friday, July 1st in theaters everywhere.
Watch where the puck goes. It went up through the middle. Now it drops down in front of Doug Lidstrom, who was put in a very awkward position by Jay Wells. And Mike Richter made a nice save. And that was the big boys on the ice, Antoski and Hunter, who had the scoring chance. You can't go through the middle like that. You want to bank the puck off the board, so Jay Wells will know that for his next shift.
Kovalov against Linden for the faceoff. It's an even thus far. Canucks away with the puck. Brett Hedekin. Boy, has he had a great series. Good rush. Zubov picks him up. Takes the puck away. Off the boards for Kovalov. Missed it. Brown goes for it. Little pick from Courtnall helps him get free. On the boards. Lafayette picks it clear. Larmer sends it back. Kovalov couldn't play it. Zubov has it. Courtnall on him. Kovalov takes the puck. Courtnall with the hit on Zubov. A giveaway. Hedekin turns. Plays it down the boards. Zubov goes to get it. Swings it around. Larmer for Kovalov. Kovalov moving. Kovalov in against Brown. He looks. He shoots. Wide. Around the boards. Larmer keeps it in.
Three on three. Kovalov had no choice but to shoot.
Kovalov tries again, but fanned on it. Bounces down. The shot went wide by Matteau. Lafayette takes over. Out for Courtnall. He's hit high and hard by Kukabum. They both went down. And they're both slow to get up. The whistle stops play. Bukabum is still down.
Boy, did he take a run at Courtnall, and this stick is stuck in the back of his jersey. He's been hit up high. Courtnall's grabbing his throat. Bukabum was the aggressor. I don't think there's any penalties to be handed out here. Matteau just missed the open net. Matteau's only had one shot on goal in his last four games. He needs offense. I think Bukabum got hit in the throat as he moves in. Look at the stick. Right there, catches Bukabum across the side of the face as Courtnall put the stick up to protect himself as big Bukabum comes across. Boom! Oh, my.
So that's Courtnall's stick that's stuck up in his jersey.
I don't think there's a penalty to be handed out. That was a heck of a collision with Bukabum, the biggest Ranger defenseman, hitting Courtnall, who's been on fire with four goals in the last two games. Matteau needs shots. He's been involved. He's been taking the body a little bit. Puck lands, he chops at it, but it zings just wide. Again, he's only had one shot on goal in the last four games, and he's criticized himself for not being in position to get the shots. Well, on that play, he was in position and just missed.
Matteau works on the stick. A little over 7 minutes gone by in the first period. There's no score in the game.
So far, Terry Gregson, the referee, not calling any cheap penalties, and I like that.
Jay Wells with the puck. McIntyre lost his stick around the boards. Tied up. Hunter going for it. Lidstrom plays it. Kachinov stick out of the zone. Dumped in by Kiprios. McLean stops it. Around the glass. Bounces down. Lidstrom missed it. Wells has to go get it. John McIntyre bearing down on him. Long pass to Gilbert. Back to the other side. The race is on for the puck. Gilbert did not get to the red line. Icing his whistle. Kiprios was after the puck.
Kiprios said that if he played, he'd like to get some hits early. And on this shift, he threw one into Antoski along the far boards. Antoski, the biggest player, 240 pounds in the series. But it's easy to say that when you haven't played for quite a few weeks and you know how hot it is here. By the way, the Madison Square Garden people had the air conditioning on all night long to try and keep it cool in here to help the ice be good for the game.
Former Rangers Mark Hislop, Dave Maloney, Frank Beaton, Wolf Nielsen. In the front row, the big whistle, Bill Chadwick, Mike McEwen next to him. A little farther down, Mike Backman, Ron Duguay is here, and Johnny Mac wearing the Rangers cap. Ryan Leach with the puck. No score of the game. 12:15 to go. First period, a giveaway. Adams sends it back, gave it up to Bukabul. Leach, still checking his boy. Here's Graves on the move. Dumps to the corner. Adams gets there. Anderson gets there on hand. Moved up the boards. Bukabul stops it. Graves. Messier in the corner. Checked by Adams. Messier keeps moving. Fires. Stopped by McLean. Lume chopped that by Anderson. Craven's got the puck. Bure goes wide to the right side. Craven carries. Bure trailing. Craven for Bure. Stopped by Richter. Trying to gain control. One hands it around the board. Bukabul tries to clear and does. Jeff Brown after it. Messier got tripped up as he was tangled up with Brett Hedekin. Bure looking for some space. Lomesso for Ronning. Ronning against Lowe. Ronning moves back, plays it down the board to Lomesso. Lomesso picked up by McTavish. Now it's Bure who has stayed on. Long shift for him, intercepted by Tekin, and he waits, sends it out to Kevin Lowe. Avoids Bure. Canucks send it back in. McTavish bumps with Lomesso all the way in. Richter waits. Lomesso tries to take it. Oh, he's strong. Ronning is in there. Zuboff works it loose. Just under 11 minutes to go in the first period with no score in the game. The game for the Stanley Cup championship. Dave Babich back for it. Rangers have four shots on goal. Canucks three.
I don't think there's been a good one, though, Sam. Not a quality scoring chance yet.
As the two teams Ronning
have really had to work for their scoring chances so far.
Wells just dumps it out. Sliding all the way down. There'll be an icing if Diddick gets there first, and he does. Play stops with 10:32 to go in the first period. No score in the game.
Your Tri-State Quality Ford dealer takes on the world with Ford Taurus.
Let's get ready to rumble!
With a V6, dual airbags, and four-wheel anti-lock brakes, Taurus is a better value than the imports. And now you can lease a new Taurus for just $249 a month for 24 months with $1,850 down.
The best-selling car in America, Ford Taurus.
See your Ford dealer and see for yourself.
Hi from Snapple, an iced tea drinker from Atlanta writes, are your commercials for real or are the people just actors? Ask them yourself.
The attention guy, yeah. Come here.
I said the only good thing that ever came out of New York was Snapple.
Come here, Shane. Oh, I can't believe it.
So you don't think the people are real? Well, we're real, Luther.
I believe you now.
Made from the best stuff on earth.
I'm a real person.
You can now order a souvenir copy of the Rangers Stanley Cup Finals program for only $7 plus $2.95 for shipping and handling. You order call 1-800-769-8843.
Rangers have iced the puck. They're not taking any chances. That puts pressure on faceoffs. And Kovalov just won one against Trevor Linden.
Ryan Flynn has the puck. Now Yurki Lune. Rangers have Kovalov, Larmer, and Mateau on the ice. Kovalov sliding across. Bounces down the line, he turns and he shoots off the glove of McLean. Bounces in the corner.
Now that's the best shot the Rangers have had as the puck goes into the stands along the corner. Steve Larmer was maybe the most open a Ranger forward's been so far in the first period. We're nearing the midpoint of the period. And he's got a good shot, even from bad angles. He went high to the glove side. And Kirk McLean made the save. There you see how much room he's got.
and a good shot because it was back against the grain. He was going to his left, shoots a puck back to his right. And that'll sometimes fool a goaltender, but not Kirk McLean. By the way, Kirk McLean is making his 49th consecutive start in the playoffs for Vancouver, and Pat Quinn has coached every one of them.
Brown pressed by Gilbert, moves it around the boards to Hedekin. Canucks move out. Cortinall with Linden and Lafayette. Leach after the puck, gets there. Leach starts to move. Linden slows it down. Leach fires out. Back the other way. Lafayette had to wait for his teammate to get onside, but Jeff Cortinall couldn't do it. The whistle stops play. 9:46 remaining in the first period of a scoreless game. And remember, when you're having good times with friends, use good sense and drink responsibly. Please, know when to say when. Reminder from Budweiser.
Rangers are pressing. Vancouver's pressing. The Rangers, in my opinion, have had the one good shot. That was by Larmer. And I don't think Vancouver, aside from the one scramble when Antoski and Hunter were in front, have had themselves a quality scoring chance. So these two teams are trying to play smart defensively and maybe force the other team into some kind of a mistake.
McIntyre started the year with the New York Rangers. Picked up by the Vancouver Canucks. Fired in. Leach takes a hit from McIntyre. Graves battling along the board, trying to dig it loose. McIntyre and Leach in the corner. Hunter against Graves.
And Toski and Leach. Or McIntyre and Leach, pardon me.
Graves. Chopped at by Hunter. Anderson knocked down by Hedekin. Messier moving in, and Koski's got the puck. Around the boards for Hunter, and he's hit by Bukaboom. The puck slides into the Rangers zone, and Leach gets there.
Bukaboom has come back and played hard, taking the body since he was injured on a hit with Cortinall.
Messier slowed down by Bore, gets by him. Messier cuts in, still with the puck. Nice pass to Zubov. Zubov feeds Leach. Leach scores! Brilliant passing play by Messier. Zubov with Leach finishing. The Rangers lead 1-0.
Now that's hockey. Mark Messier, you'll see, get control of puck and power through Bure right there. Now when he gains the zone, he's got to make the smart play. Watch Leach take his time to hit the open net, which he does. Messier's a magnet. When he draws people to him, others are open. Beautiful play by the big boys for the Rangers. Messier with power. Now watch him draw people to him and pass the puck with authority. Now Zubov has his defense partner in on the play, and bingo, it's 1-0.
Zubov and Leach, they were the keys to giving the Rangers the big lead in the series. They combined. Shot by Craven goes wide, bounces down. Larmer back for the puck. Bure is after it.
Vancouver has come back quickly to score in this series after the Rangers have.
Babich is open. The shot was knocked down. Kovalov has got it in the jersey. And play stops. Leach gets the goal. His 11th of the playoffs from Zubov and Messier at 11:02. Messier has scored in 21 of the 23 Ranger games in the playoffs. Ryan Leach has only been shut out in 4 games in the playoffs. And he ties Dennis Potvin and Al MacInnis for most goals by a defenseman in the Stanley Cup Final.
Now the avalanche of support in Madison Square Garden goes towards the New York Rangers from their fans. Look at Messier draw two people. Now you see the pick by Graves, Adam, and you see Leach wide open, and he took his time to make sure of his shot. Alexei Kovalov has been good defensively.
Lynn down low off the stick of Linden and knocked away by Richter. Around the net, Wells chasing. Wells fires it out of the zone. All the way down on goal. Kirk McLean has to play it. Off the boards. Larmer bumps Cortinall. It's out of the zone. Sent back in by Lidstrom. 8:10 to go in the first, and the Rangers have the first goal of the game for the first time since game 2. Linden dumps in off the corner board. Cortinall gets there. Shot knocked down by Richter. What a play by Cortinall. Hustling to the puck with Lidstrom on him.
Cortinall's a great shooter. And he loves to shoot more so than pass. Now, Vancouver, Sam, they always seem to show that they have the ability to come back right away. And they have not backed up since the Rangers scored the goal.
Not at all. Graves gets out of the zone, slowed down by Jelena. Messier chases after it. Messier's got it. Graves trying to get loose in front, was tangled up with his own man, Glenn Anderson, to puck up the board. And out comes Jelena. Across to Mameso. Mameso against Bukaboom and Graves. Jelena's got the puck. Bukaboom staying with Mameso. Anderson against Ronning. Ronning with a back pass. Ground played in the cross. Jelena tied up with Anderson. Messier goes over to help out. His pass off the skate. Rangers trying to work it out of the zone. Finally do.
But Anderson got hurt on the play. He's down. And now there's a stoppage because of the injury. And you can see he's been cut. I don't know what happened. The players wanted Mameso. Momesso's been a mean, big, tough player in this series. And it looks like by the way the Rangers are going after him, he may be the person involved with the Anderson play. Mameso has done his job. Absolutely. And his job is to use his size and to play as tough as possible. And believe me, he's big. 215, 6'3". Jelena and Anderson battle. Messier's in there. Now, the puck just misses, and there's the stick by Mameso as he went into Messier. Anderson was already down on his knees. Boy, Mameso was looking to his left. That's where Anderson's face was.
I don't know if it was intentional.
I know.
Because Mameso was going to
Messier. He went into Messier, right. Yeah.
We'll step out for a moment. 7:01 to go, first period. Rangers are leading.
Guys are good.
Who are you calling guys?
Yeah. Looks like you're in the finals, ma'am.
For the great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light.
You're the defending ladies' pool champion?
Yes, I am.
The house is this room, brick and mortar. A home is what'll take place in this room when we're all finished. What takes place inside of a house really makes it a home, and what takes place inside of one of our stores makes it a special place for the customers. What we are about is service. We're in the yes business. Yes, we accept American Express. The last thing that Home Depot is into is putting limits on customers.
The American Express card is welcomed at the Home Depot and lots of other places close to home.
Ranger medical team checking in on Glenn Anderson.
Dr. Nissenson looking on with David Smith. The referee's job is to keep the players in the game whenever possible. And if they did not think it was done on purpose, or if they didn't see it, that's the way it goes. It has to be conclusive and it has to be intentional. And I don't think it was. As Mameso went into Messier, Anderson was already down on his knees. And did he ever take the stick across the face?
Bukaboom sends it down the ice.
Highly important for the Rangers, too, not to get carried away with Mameso and take a penalty.
Icing. Good effort by McTavish. Tied up Babich originally, but the third man, down the ice was Vancouver Canuck to make the touch for icing. 6:48 to go in the first period. Rangers leading 1-0 on a goal by Brian Leetch at 11:02.
Shots are 7-6 in favor of the Rangers. There's only the one odd man rush by Vancouver, and that was very early in the period when Kovalov forced the offside. Glenn Anderson's nose is obviously broken. It's been cut. It's bleeding quite badly. But in this situation, you don't go to the locker room unless it's the end of the period. You try and get it closed up. You'll see there where David Smith is shoving the packing up the nose itself to stop the bleeding so he can get back on the ice.
Hard to breathe with the packing.
Yeah, you breathe through your mouth. There's no problem. It's hockey.
Noonan for Leetch. He's tied up by Lume. Big crowd in the crease as Lafayette's tying up Tikkanen. McTavish battling Lume. Puck kicked free. Noonan gets there. McTavish against Lume in the corner. It's loose again. Noonan's got it. He's checked there by Glenn. Noonan moves it. McTavish tied up with Lume. Tikkanen working. Can't get out in front.
What the Rangers want if this is their game plan. Dump the puck and cycle and work the Vancouver defense. Try and draw a penalty, but don't get three forwards caught deep across the goal line, in behind the goal net.
Bukaboom's there to stop it. McTavish, penalty upcoming. The
That's
Rangers
it.
Working so hard, drew a penalty on the Canucks. First power play of the game to the Rangers.
That's a great shift. Absolutely great. That's exactly what the Rangers talked about. Sam, on the way back from Vancouver, the Rangers on the aircraft look at video of fundamental mistakes, what they weren't doing, and this was one of them.
And it was a good ploy by the Rangers to set this up and have the players understand what was missing. Hard work was one of them. And there you see McTavish draw the penalty when Lou May did not have a stick.
You can see what Yurke Lume thought of the call.
Taking it. You got to work to win games like this. It's one-on-one battles all over the ice surface, and if you can work the other team deep and continue to control the puck. Remember, Jeff Bukaboom pinched and kept the puck alive. You'll see it right there. The play is still alive. Now McTavish can go after the puck. Broken stick and a penalty. And the Rangers power play goes to work.
Lume for cross-checking at 14:03. And the Rangers have the first power play of the game. They are 4-for-25 on the power play in the series, with Kovalov having 3 of the 4, Zubov the other one.
Vancouver does not have a shorthanded goal, but always watch Pavel Bure.
Leach takes the shot, save, rebound, and Messier was tied up trying to draw a penalty. Here's Kovalov shooting, and a save by McClain. Bure to the puck. Bure was hit by Messier. Kovalov keeps it in. Nice pass to Graves. He's checked. And Brown fires it all the way down.
That initial shot from the point was deflected by Messier. McClain made a great save.
Bure all over Leach. Good pressure. Zubov has the puck. Bure and Craven. Brown and Hedekin for Vancouver. Zubov and Leach. Messier, Graves, and Kovalov for the Rangers. Kovalov to the puck. Now Graves. He scores! Oh. Adam Graves! It's a power play goal, and the Rangers lead 2-0. They needed him.
Look who's on the puck. Vancouver stands up. Kovalov stays wide, and Adam Graves with a beautiful shot. All series long, he shot to the catching glove side. This time he said he's going to space his shots out. He goes to the stick side. What a pass. What a shot. Power play goal for the Rangers, and they're having a great time here celebrating in Madison Square Garden. Vancouver tried to stand up. Kovalov stayed wide. Oh, my, did the Rangers make it look nice with some great skill play.
Adam Graves has gone 10 games without a goal. The man who led the Rangers in goal scoring in the regular season with 52, setting a team record, breaks loose for his first goal of this series. His 10th of the playoffs from Kovalov and Zubov at 14:45.
Again, after a goal, you can't sit and celebrate because the other team will get one right back. That's how good they are. You have to remain focused.
Graves to Messier and around the boards. Graves after. Kovalov remains on with Messier and Graves after a strong power play shift. Back pass to Bukaboom. Toward the net. Save McClain. He holds it with a glove as Messier causing some distraction with a stick.
Yesterday, Adam Graves said it was the first time in 10 days that he's been able to relax. And there's no doubt in my mind that the additional day between Game 6 and Game 7 was one the Rangers took advantage of. People like Brian Leach said he relaxed. Adam Graves relaxed. Look at this. This is a power play goal off a rush. Vancouver stands up. Zubov goes down but gets the puck through. Now looking over on the other side. Messier was there in case of a rebound. Beautiful shot by Graves. The power play works. That's the fourth game of the series the Rangers have had a power play goal. This one's the biggest.
We talked about Leach being a factor in the games in which the Rangers lost. Zubov's absence, he had had only 5 shots in the last 3 games. They have been all over him and cut him down. He has 2 assists in this game thus far.
Vancouver's dumped the puck a lot, but they haven't done a lot with it. There they try it again, see?
Giveaway, kept in by Courtnall, blocked in front by Lowe. He got tripped up, but he covers the puck and gets a whistle to stop play.
You know where the puck was. You see the Rangers on every stoppage, they're not backing up. Vancouver's trying to press here. They are a very good hockey club, but the Rangers are playing with an air of confidence. At every stoppage, there you saw the Rangers move over the Tavish, push Linda. They're on their home turf, and they're trying to take advantage of it.
And it's not only confidence, John. It's an air of determination also. You can see it in every shift. Mark Messier. Game 7, 9 times. 4 goals, 7 assists, 11 points when he's played in his 7th game. Bukaboom has the puck. 4:25 to go in the first period. The Rangers have outshot the Canucks 11-6 and lead 2-0. McTavish hooking his way by Glenn. Noonan in after the puck. He's tied up with Linden. Noonan along the boards to pass across. Throw by Tinkin. Bukaboom's got it toward the net. Stick aside by McClain. Got that cleared by Lume.
Tavish having a big first period for the Rangers. He slingshotted past Glenn to negate the icing, and the Rangers had a shot on goal.
Tinkin wraps up Lume up with the puck. Moved off the boards with Brian Glenn. Back to get it is Jay Wells. Down in the zone. Canucks go over the player. Jeff Brown across to Brett Hennepin. And the crowd alive. Something the Rangers needed badly. They've gotten the crowd into the game immediately. Icing is whistled and a standing ovation for the Rangers.
They're enjoying the first period, but remember, it's only the first period. Mats McNabb, a true gentleman who works with the New Jersey Devils, came up with a nugget. He said there's never been a Stanley Cup team win a championship with a captain that's been traded for. The Rangers have one. That's the best thing that's happened to this franchise and maybe ever. It's Mark Messier. He's a Ranger now, and he's got his team on a roll with a great first period.
This could be the crowning jewel of his career, John, if he can... If the Rangers come through tonight.
A long way to go. The Rangers want to keep dumping the puck deep, keep working Vancouver, and when you do that, you eliminate Vancouver's defense from joining the rush up ice.
Komolov goes forward with a face-off. The shot deflected wide. Good play by Komolov. Zubov comes over. Mameso reaching out after him.
I'll tell you what Matteau did. He just pulled the net off. He was trapped in behind the goal. He's lucky he didn't get caught. It would have been a penalty for delay of game.
Play continuing, then finally blow the whistle.
Matteau was stuck in behind Kirk McLean's net, who's he now, the goaltender, is telling the linesman, Matteau, and Matteau wasn't very good at it. It took him about 4 pushes and shoves to pull the net off the mooring to try and get play stopped because he was caught up ice. And he's very lucky that the referee didn't see. The linesman can't call it. It's a minor, unless it's too many men on the ice. He can't call this delay of game. But the referee, if he would have seen it, it would have been a penalty for Matteau for delay of game.
3:17 to go in the first period. Rangers with a 2-0 lead. Stephan Matteau has not scored a goal since scoring the series winner in Game 7 against the New Jersey Devils. This is the third time. Well, the linesman steps in between Mameso and Noonan.
And who is it? Again, Vic Sergio, who's played a great series. He's been belligerent. He's been mean. And the Rangers are trying to take him and negate that stuff.
This is the third Game 7. Ever played here in Madison Square Garden, and the Rangers have won the previous two, both against the New Jersey Devils. Nikitin picking up the loose puck. He's tied up. Pass off the skate of Jelena. Mameso grabs hold of Noonan and pulled him down. That prompted the roar.
He got away with one there, no doubt about that.
Off the skate of Jelena. He's hip-checked by Leach. And a penalty is upcoming. Is this a penalty?
No, I believe it's offside.
Okay. I thought I saw Gregson's arm go up.
When Jelena was hit, he jumped up to try to avoid the hit. Mameso reached out and caught Noonan up high. And the Rangers are trying to get Mameso off his game so he doesn't destroy Brian Leach. Look at this. It's a good cross-check across the shoulder. Terry Gregson lets that go. More of a shove than a cross-check. He had one hand on the stick.
Yeah.
When you see that, good look at it. Oh, Jelena jump. Boom! Oh my, we're seeing some good hitting. Both clubs involved. See Jelena try to turn and avoid the hit. Brian Leach came across with a good hit.
Messier back on with Glenn Anderson returning for the first time since he took the stick in the face from Mameso. Puck is knocked down by Babich. Babich and Anderson jabbing one another with the stick.
Again, you're seeing the Rangers try to play a belligerent game on their home ice. Babich had the puck stuck in his equipment. Anderson gave him a shot. So Babich gave him a shot back, and Messier was over. The Rangers are just trying to play a very intense team game that they've been known for all season long.
Controlled aggression.
That's it. They both shot Vancouver 12-6. Remember, the shots were 7-6 about 5 minutes ago. The next goal is so important. And the next power play might be very important. Vancouver's got no offense, no offense yet.
Giveaway. Adams turns and shoots, and it went wide. It went through with Richter, but just wide of the net. Bure gets away from Messier. Bure around the net. Bure turns. Bure looking for the shot, and he can't get it to the net. It rolled right through the crease. What a move by Bure. He did everything but put it in the net. Another shot is a save by Richter, and it's cleared by Messier. What a fantastic move by Pavel Bure.
Not a player in the league that can find a way to get the shot on goal any better than Bure. It looks like he's got nothing, and he'll make something out of it. And Sam, not only on the forehand, but also on the backhand.
Up behind the net, taken away by the Canucks. Out of the zone comes Sean Antoski, trying to get it to Hunter, plays down the boards. Hunter gets low, low chops at him. Dubov hit by Hunter, and the whistle stops play.
Boy, good interference by Mantel, who's working in this one. Antoski, he's like a missile. He wants to seek a Ranger and destroy the player deep in the player's zone. But he couldn't get through. Mantel held him up. Craig Adams shot. I thought it was in. Look at that. Oh, just wide of the goalpost. Craven had his hands up. Now it's showtime for Pavel Bure, who shows he can take a hit twice there. And watch this. You look like he's got nothing to do. Nowhere to shoot the puck, but watch him go and find something. He's got everybody reaching. And he's finally hooked in the last second, and the puck just grazes wide. A little hook by Brian Leach stopped the good shot with the open net, and then Jeff Bukaboom helped out. Pavel Bure, you can see exactly his frustration. His first 50 goals he scored this year, 33 were on the road. He doesn't get intimidated.
1:36 to go. In the first period, the Rangers holding a 2-0 lead. Hedekin takes the puck. Nice pass to Linden. Lafayette to his right. Linden carries across and dumps in. Richter puts it in the corner. McTavish with Courtnall on him. Almost giving up to Lafayette. Rangers pack it ahead. Taking it out to Noonan. Noonan across against Jeff Brown. Toward the net. And it almost was batted in. It almost went in off McTavish. Went off the stick of McLean. Then McTavish heading for the net. Had it go off him, but just wide. And then the net was knocked off.
Taking it in ahead again, getting a one another. McTavish drove to the net. The Rangers came out of their zone nicely after Mike Richter had some trouble giving McTavish the puck with a handoff back in the Rangers zone. And up ice they come. Noonan to the net. Look who's driving to the net. And he's upended. That's McTavish by Hedekin. And Kirk McLean with just a little extra. Well, you don't have a helmet, cover your head. Good little play by the goaltender. Sticking the puck aside. And you love to drive to the net away from the puck in case it comes to you. Look at the stick play. Good play. And there's McTavish. Good play. McTavish has had a good period, not only deep in the Vancouver zone, but also winning draws.
Brett Hedekin and Esa-Tikkanen will sit for 2 minutes. And it'll be 4-on-4 action with 1:10 remaining in the first period.
Wonder if Pat Quinn, in this situation, is the coach of a team down 2-0, puts Pavel Bure on the ice to go for it, or does he wonder about the Rangers, because Messier, I think, is fresh and Leach is fresh. If they go for it and they get beat for a goal, it's 3-0. Will he try and play defensive here to end the period and get out of it down by two?
What would you do, coach?
Oh, I know what I'd do if I was a Rangers coach. I have those guys on the ice that you're looking at. Leach, Messier, Graves, and Bukaboo, and Pavel Bure sitting on the bench.
Taken and Hedekin 2 minutes each for roughing. Messier with Graves, Bukaboom and Leach for the Rangers. Linden and Courtnall. Lume and Glenn for Vancouver. Linden wins the faceoff. Lume chases. And the puck cleared up into the crowd. Following the conclusion of the first period, Al Trotwig will talk to two members of the Hockey Hall of Fame, the keepers of the cup. The cup, which is here under safekeeping and awaiting. There's Mayor Rudolph Giuliani in attendance with his son Andrew. And then Bob Page will have an update at the MSG Sports Desk. JD and I will have first period highlights. Hope you'll stay with us. With just under 1 minute to go in the first period, the Rangers leading 2-0. Messier won the faceoff. The puck in the corner. Courtnall goes back to get it. Ducks with 12-9 in favor of the Rangers. Trevor Linden moving with the puck. Courtnell trailing in. Richter goes out to get it. Messier plays it. Back the other way to Buchanan.
There's another play, even if it's 4-on-4. The Rangers force Linden into dumping the puck. Here's a pass that goes astray. And it's now icing with 34.2 seconds to go. And a very important draw in the Rangers zone. Now Vancouver, remember, they have to put the players on the ice first. And the Rangers have the option of then making the change or the matchup they want. That's the advantage of home ice. Pat Quinn has put Pavel Bure on the ice now. And the Rangers take Bukabum off, put Zuboff on the ice. Zuboff and Leach, when they've been on the ice against Bure in the series, have had success against them. They seem to think alike what they want to do with the puck and when they're defending the man with the puck.
Messier against Craven. Craven, Bure, Brown, and Babbage for Vancouver. Messier and Zuboff get together.
Brian Leach skated over to Mike Keenan to get instructions as to what to do on the alignment for the faceoff. See, Messier's left hand is turned over. That means he's drawing the puck possibly back in that direction.
Leach tells Graves something, possibly that he's going to cover it. No, Graves is going to Bure. Chuck from the point goes wide. Down the boards. Bure is there, and he's hit by Messier. Messier is bumped by Craven. Leach looking for the puck. Messier's got it. Rangers break out. 3-on-2. Messier across. Dropped to Graves. Taken away by Craven. Clears the zone. Off the stick of Leach. And Richter goes out to play it away from Bure. Richter holding. Graves has it. Lifts it clear. Final seconds of the first period. They're on their feet at Madison Square Garden. The Rangers have a 2-0 lead. One period complete in the game for the Stanley Cup.
Very intense, very hard fought. However, it was the skill level of people like Brian Leach and Mark Messier and Zuboff and Graves that gives the Rangers a 2-0 lead.
A good period for the Rangers. Leach and Graves score. Now Trotwick coming up in a moment.
In Canada, they learn to play hockey before they learn to walk. So it's no wonder Bill Christian exports his hockey sticks from the U.S. to Canada. And it's no wonder he chooses AT&T. They give him discounts to every phone in Canada, not just two of them. That's his AT&T Business Advantage. And it's turned Bill into an all-star stick handler.
AT&T works for me.
Get ready for a summer of more chills, more thrills, more excitement, more suspense. Get ready for summer sports from the New York Lottery. Six new games, six ways to win up to $5,000 instantly. Summer sports, they're the hottest tickets in town.
Yeah, I know I'm going to go to college because I know my dad has the money for it.
Kids, they say the darndest things, don't they, Dad?
All this traffic. You gotta get it first.
Get it first on 1010 Wins.
When I want the news, I want it fast.
Get it fast on 1010 Wins.
Hey, what's the weather doing now?
Get it now on 1010 Wins. 24 hours a day, get top news stories. Weather, traffic, transit, and sports. Get it first. Get it fast. Get it now on 1010 Wins.
You give us 22 minutes, we'll give you the world.
Balloons, songs, and pushy salesmen. Who needs it? At LaFresh Ford, we make buying a car a pleasurable experience. We're here to work with you, not confuse you. Come in, sit in a car of your choice. Get a feel for it. A new or quality used car. We provide low financing, lease plans, and Ford factory guarantee on all our cars, new or used. LaFresh Ford, 718-417-4242. A name you can trust.
What has happened at Madison Square Garden in the first period is there in Times Square in lights for all to see. But there isn't a Ranger fan who's watching, who's taking it easy. We're with now Scott North and Phil Pritchard. These are the men who are the keepers of the cup. And for many years, it was Lefty Reed, guys. And I know Lefty used to lose a little bit of himself every time he handed the cup over to a bunch of players who were going to sip champagne from it, lose it at times, kick it, grow plants in it.
How about you? In the short few years that you've kept the cup, you have a special feeling for it?
Well, Lefty passed it on to us in 89-90. In the past 5 years, it's become quite interesting for us carrying the cup around and that, and especially today here in Game 7. The noise that's going on here, to be quite a moment when the player carries it around the ice tonight.
Now, Scott, in those days, Lefty used to buy an airplane ticket. It used to say on the ticket, Stanley Cup. But nowadays, you guys take it around the country in a different way, don't you?
Yeah, it's in its own box. It's a little more discreet, I would say. We make sure an agent comes up from the airline that we're with and picks the cup up and takes it down. Quite often, they'll even let us go down and watch them put it right on the plane. So it sits underneath with the other baggage, and we just make sure it gets there and gets off at the other end.
So where is it right now, and how will it be brought onto the ice? Because we're going to give it one way or the other tonight to somebody.
That's right. Right now it's in the back of the officials' room, and with about 10 minutes left, providing there's a winner within sight, we'll bring it out, and it'll be the red carpet treatment from there on in out to center ice, and then Mr. Bettman will take it from there.
Well, they've polished it up. It looks beautiful, and they will bring it on the ice with white gloves. We'll have more from the Garden with Bob Page at the sports desk with the Rangers up 2-0 after one.
Debbie, these shots are fabulous. Beautiful, Debbie.
Better than the last time, Tony?
Absolutely.
It's my job to make sure people look good. A few weeks ago, while doing test shots with Debbie, I noticed something. Dandruff. So I told her about Head & Shoulders. You see, regular shampoos merely rinse flakes away, so they could come back. But look, Head & Shoulders helps stop flakes from even forming. See the difference? Yeah, picture perfect. Head & Shoulders turns dandruff problems into beautiful hair.
How you doing? Is this the illegal chop shop?
Eddie Murphy.
Kill him.
Hey, hey, hey.
Beverly Hills Cop 3.
Trust me on this one, okay?
Rated R. It's on May 25th.
Since your face can't adjust to your razor should adjust to your face, which is exactly why we designed the Schick Tracer. The Schick Tracer is the only razor with blades that bend and flex to the unique shape of your face. So the Tracer gets in close for a clean, comfortable shave. And since you can't change your face, maybe you should change your razor. Schick. You're changing the face of shaving.
In the territory of the beast, there are no boundaries. Jack Nicholson, Michelle Pfeiffer, Wolf, rated R, at theaters Friday.
The Privilege Plus card at Nobody Beats the Wiz. You pay 0% interest for 90 days. 0%. Nobody beats the Wiz.
New York Rangers hockey is brought to you in part by the New York State Lottery. Play Lotto. Hey, you never know. By Coca-Cola Classic. Enjoy all the Rangers' excitement with Coca-Cola Classic. Always an icebreaker, always Coca-Cola. And by Toyota. I love what you do for me, Toyota.
Bob Page rejoining you from our Sports Desk studios once again. Most of the non-biased media people I spoke with before tonight's game, in other words, folks who are not from New York or Vancouver, were picking the Rangers to win. Former Montreal Canadiens star Gilles Tremblay is here tonight working as a color commentator on the CBC French broadcast.
The Rangers have a better hockey club, but in a seven game, you know, anything can happen. I've been through it many times, and it's not always the good team who can come out of it. But that team came out during the regular season with 34 points ahead of Vancouver, so that means something too. Some of the boys have been kept very quiet. I'm talking about Adam Graves, who got 52 goals, so at one point, those guys can be dangerous tonight.
Graves did have a goal tonight, as you know, and Gilles Tremblay was picking the Rangers to win. Meanwhile, there is another championship series going on in town. It's amazing how the Rangers have virtually knocked the Knicks and the Rockets right off the back pages. But tomorrow night, the Knicks will be facing a veritable must-win situation at the Garden, trailing the Houston Rockets 2-1 in the NBA Finals.
They're going to come out with a lot of fire and a lot of pressure on the game on Wednesday, and I just feel like for us, we just have to come out and match that intensity. And if we don't, we're going to get blown. If we do, I feel like we'll give ourselves a chance to win.
We feel that we played well enough in spurts, you know, where it could have went either way, but it didn't. They're up 2-1. Now we have to come back on Wednesday, try to even it up.
Also in the NBA today, John Lucas named coach and GM of the Sixers, and ML Carr has taken over the basketball operations of the Boston Celtics. More in a moment.
Sports Desk is brought to you by your Tri-State Quality Ford dealers, who are winning back America with five of the top 10 bestsellers. Now, your Tri-State Quality Ford dealer takes on the world with the Ford Windstar.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's get ready to rumble!
The minivan of the future is here today with front-wheel drive, dual airbags, four-wheel anti-lock brakes, lower step-in height, and 5-mile-per-hour bumpers. Plus, Windstar comes with free 24-hour roadside assistance.
The winner and new champion, Ford Windstar!
See the new Windstar at your Tri-State Quality Ford dealer.
This is the ride you get with our competitor's gasoline.
How long is this gonna be?
Looks like a wiener brain.
Wrong brain. Ow! Mom!
This is the ride you get with Sunoco gasoline. Fill up with Super or Ultra at a participating Sunoco station, and we'll give you 5 free collector's edition baseball cards. Collect the set featuring 24 of some of today's hottest players.
Hey, how about all mine for
once
all
again,
year?
A more enjoyable ride from Sunoco.
Well, if the Rangers have knocked the Knicks off the back pages of the tabloids, the first-place Yankees getting almost no publicity these days. They are losing tonight at Baltimore, 2-1, bottom of the fifth of their game. Out at Shea, Doc Gooden blanking the Phillies so far, 1-0 in the sixth inning. Rangers now 40 minutes away from the Cup. We're back after this.
After the game on NBC, tune into MSG Sports Desk for the New York Knicks special NBA Finals postgame edition, Wednesday night on MSG.
What you don't know won't hurt you. Ignorance is bliss. The less you know, the better. And you expect to survive in New York? To subscribe to Cranes, call 1-800-487-4871.
I couldn't believe it.
Started when I was about 22, 23.
I was practically bald.
Men's Hair Now can make you look like you used to.
They've got this Dermabond process.
It's completely undetectable.
My girlfriend doesn't even know about it.
It's so easy, you don't even have to think about
it. I'm more confident now than I've ever been.
Now you can have a full head of hair again with Men's Hair Now. Men and women, if you're losing your hair, call 1-800-HAIR-202 for a free consultation. 1-800-HAIR-202.
Teamwork. It's the cornerstone of any championship season. It makes good teams great. It's what makes great teams dynasties. And it's beautiful to watch. MCS Fast Responsive Service and Canon Technology are a team you can count on. Nobody knows office technology as well as Canon. Nobody knows Canon as well as MCS. They work together like this. MCS Canon. One is a great reason to buy the other.
I'm Manon Rayon, the first woman to play in a professional hockey league.
At Tony Roma's, we're famous for making America's best ribs, like our Blue Ridge Smokies. Thick, meaty ribs basted with a smoky molasses sauce for just $9.99.
If you want great ribs, make Tony Roma's your goal.
Sam Rosen, John Davidson, Al Trotwig, Emil Francis back at Madison Square Garden. Rangers with a 2-0 lead, and here's how they got it.
Well, it's a rush up ice. You see Leach beat the first man there. Now Messier can show why he's billed as one of the most powerful skaters in the league. He fights through the check of Pavel Bure. Then he draws two people to him, Bure and Dinick. Now the Rangers get into open areas. Here's a beautiful pass across, Zuboff to Leach. And only a Brian Leach would take his time to make sure he hit the net in a situation like that. Composure at its best.
Power play Rangers.
Just watch the head and the face of Zubov. You can see him thinking, looking, waiting. He'll draw two men to him right here. Brown and Craven. That means Kovalov's got the puck, and watch the other defenseman go to him. That leaves Graves wide open. He goes to the stick side for a change. He scores a power play goal.
And now Bure puts on a show. Big chance here.
This was Vancouver's best shift of the period. The Rangers had the 2-0 lead. Murray Craven thought that shot was in. Look at his hands. Look at his stick. Oh, no, it's not in. Keep working. Now you'll see Pavel Bure take the hit of Bukaboom. Here comes Messier. He's still got his balance. Some brilliance at work, and then you're going to see Brian Leetch put his stick on Bure's stick to stop the hard shot from the angle. Leetch will not give up here. Now watch what Leetch's stick does right here. Leans on the arms of Pavel Bure, and Bure can't get the good hard shot. The puck, however, does slither just wide as Jeff Bukaboom was down. That was Vancouver's best shift, and they couldn't score.
Rangers take a 2-0 lead into the second period.
There are a lot of very fine men's stores in New York where you can pay a lot for great clothes. But there is a more intelligent choice. There's Rothmans on Union Square. It's the least expensive way to buy expensive clothes. Rothmans, the more intelligent way to buy men's clothes.
Is it right? You didn't get your hand in it.
Well, where am I gonna get the hand?
Oh! I told you that was hard.
You're not doing it right. Don't go fluffing.
Still working with prehistoric copiers?
Uh-oh.
Get a Mita. Every Mita copier buyer's lab tested earned their highest rating for uptime.
You're gonna drop the paper.
I'm not gonna drop.
For a more productive future, the times demand Mita. Call 1-800-ABC-MITA. Just a little reminder to make a trip to Dunkin' Donuts.
My father started out to be a banker and ended up an innkeeper. I think people fantasize with travel. They envision going to exotic places. If you're going to be an innkeeper, you better make people comfortable and happy. Because we're a global company, we wanted a card that would give broad credit privileges throughout the world. And the American Express corporate card was the best for us to select.
The American Express corporate card is welcomed at lots of places that make you feel at home.
New York Rangers hockey is brought to you in part by Kane Weber. We believe our most important investment is an investment in relationships. By Snapple Natural Beverages, made from the best stuff on earth. And by Midas, who asked you to stop in for an undercar inspection. It's the Midas way, the way it should be.
Pretty good time to drive the streets of Manhattan. Very little traffic with most of New York watching Game 7 here at the Garden. Now the Rangers have many members of their alumni in the penalty box here tonight to watch this game. Bill Chadwick finally in the penalty box after putting so many players there for so many years. And Ron Duguay joining us. Bill, what's your assessment of this first period?
Well, first period is being played by the Rangers the way they played all year to get where they are. And they can't let down now. Once they let down, that Vancouver team is tough, big, strong. You got to keep on them.
Well, I'm sure the Rangers know that. Ron, can you imagine the atmosphere here? I mean, I'm sure there's a little jealousy in you wishing that you could have had a moment quite like this. Can you put that into words?
Yes, a little bit of jealousy. I mean, I was there before back in 79. And there's nothing like it, and that's why I had to come here today just to get that feeling back, because I've been sitting at home watching on TV, and it's just not the same until you get into Madison Square Garden. You get involved with the fans and all the cheering and everything, and I have a nice seat. I'm right in the penalty box along the ice, and you can really feel. I mean, you can feel the bumps and bruises out there, so I really feel like I can go back 10, 15 years to what it was like for me.
Well, it's great to see you guys. I'm sure you're dying to get back out to your front row seats to watch games. Game 7, second period. It's coming up right now with Sam and JD upstairs in the skybox. Guys?
Thanks, Al. Great to see the big whistle, Bill Chadwick and Ron Duguay, JD's teammate, former teammate. First period scoring summary. I have to do this first, John. Business first, brought to you by Amtrak's Metroliner Service. 16 departures to downtown D.C. every business day. Leetch is 11th for the playoffs, 11:02. Graves 10th, 14:45. Power play goal, shots Rangers 12, Canucks 9. We start the second period skating 4-a-side with Hedekin and Tikkanen still in the penalty boxes for another 49 seconds. Leetch and Bukaboom, Messier and Graves for the Rangers, Linden and Courtnall, Babich and Didick for the Canucks.
Wonder if Vancouver will have an initial good spurt here.
Messier with a steal from Didick, rather from Courtnall. Leetch in deep with the puck. Back pass to Messier, saved by McClain. Out the other way, Linden. Leetch hustling to catch up. He does. Wickerboom to the puck. What did you start to say about Duguay?
Just wondering why he looks so good. Actually, both fellas look terrific. The big whistle and Ronnie Duguay.
Great officials of all time, Bill Chadwick, who is up in the broadcast booth. And we say hello to my predecessor and Bill's broadcast partner, Jim Gordon, who's watching at home. Just had shoulder surgery. Shot by Messier is stopped by McLean. Hope you're feeling better, Jim, and hope you're enjoying the Rangers' drive toward the Stanley Cup. Zuboff with a long shot that's blocked. Noonan tees it up. Knocked away by Lume. Picked up by Hedekin. The teams are back at full strength. Hedekin weaves his way out of the zone. Slides into the Rangers' zone. It'll be an icing. He did not gain the red line. Fans love it. Minute 16 seconds into the second period.
First shift for Pavel Bure in the second period. He had one shot on goal in the first period. That gives him 100th for the playoffs, more than any other player. Adam Graves is second now with 91. And it looked like the Rangers, by design, had Esa Tiikkanen on the ice when Bure was out there. And you look at Brian Leetch. He said the day off did him a world of good. He said he felt relaxed. I said, hey, the first two big hits in Vancouver, did that hurt you? In the first period, he said, no, actually, it woke me up. I needed it. But here, he hasn't been hit yet. He has not been hit hard by the Canucks forechecking. The Rangers have been the team forechecking.
And Leetch, Zuboff, and Messier have been involved and produced. Bukubon, wrist shot. Save McLean. Rebound is blocked. Great play by Brian Glynn, sliding across to block what might have been a Tiikkanen goal. Shot by Adams goes wide. Bounces down behind the net. Moved by Leetch away from Bure. Graven gets there to keep it in. Leetch stops it. Leetch out for the puck. Dumps into the Vancouver zone. Lume goes back to get it. Lume trying to get it ahead. It was blocked by Tiikkanen. The other way goes Brian Glynn. Jurke Lume has the puck. 2 minutes gone by in the second period. Rangers doing an excellent job keeping the puck in. Around the net comes Matteau. He's picked up there. Puck along the boards. Canucks trying to move it clear. Stopped by Zuboff. Zuboff feeding. That shot by Marber was blocked. And Bure pulls it out.
Bure with a long shift again.
Gave it up to Kevin Lowe as he goes to the bench. Rangers go the other way. Larmer lost it. Across the line, Jelena bangs with Zuboff. Lowe with Bomesso chopping at him with a stick. In front, knocked aside from running by Kovalov.
Maybe
off the boards himself.
Maybe the best game I've seen Kovalov play defensively.
He turns. He shoots. Save McLean. Drops it off and bats it into the corner. Canucks go the other way. Hedekin to Ronning. Ronning with Jelena to his right. Gave it up to Kovalov. Clears the zone. Matteau is tied up. He finds the puck. The two-line pass whistled against the Rangers. 2 minutes, 50 seconds gone by in the second period, and the Rangers are holding a 2-0 lead.
It was the best first date I ever had, and she was crazy about me.
I couldn't stand him. All he talked about was himself.
I can be a good listener.
He never shut up.
It's funny how two people can look at the same thing differently.
And I just hope she didn't think I was too, you know, serious.
Well, you know, he did have a good sense of humor.
To some, this is a great-tasting imported beer. And to others, it's a great-tasting light beer. Either way, it's Amstel Light.
What's the difference? I looked horrible anyway.
What a knockout.
With all these standard features, the advantages of owning a new GMC Safari are seemingly endless. Its lease, however, is only for 24 months. The Safari 24-month GMAC Smart Lease.
See your Tri-State GMC truck dealer.
We've been talking about Kovalov defensively. There he wrestles down running, and now he'll hustle back in the zone. And watch this. It looks like a Vancouver scoring chance. Who reaches out for the puck but Alexei Kovalov? I've never seen him pay such attention to detail defensively. That's about four good plays through the beginning of the second period and the first period all told.
It's interesting, John, we talked about Messier, Leetch, and Zuboff, and talking to associate coach Colin Campbell this morning, he said we need a big game from Kovalov.
Well, he's gotten one so far.
Loose puck in the corner, Nathan Lafayette to it, blocked by McTavish. Lafayette's pass knocked away by Noonan. Noonan breaks out with Tikkanen. Babich is back. Noonan across, looking for Tikkanen. He shoots. It trickled wide. Just went wide. Babich moves it to the board. Tikkanen gets there. McLean out to play the puck.
This line has been terrific for the Rangers. McTavish, Tikkanen, and Noonan.
Lidstrom couldn't keep it in the zone. Wells goes back to get it. On him is Lafayette. Fires it across. Lume's got it. Rangers have outshot the Canucks 5-0 here early in the second period. Leach takes it back. Backhands it ahead out of the zone. Nice pass. Glenn Anderson. It took three stitches in the nose. Moves in. Anderson gets the shot off, a save by McLean.
Rangers are doing a good job driving to the net. We saw Noonan and Tikkanen team up for a scoring chance. Here, Glenn Anderson, who had his nose stitched up between periods, gets the puck on the backhand side and drives to the net. Here's Noonan. Settles the puck across. There's Tikkanen with a shot. Saved by McLean as the Rangers are driving to the net. Now you'll see the Rangers head up ice again. And this time Glenn Anderson will go one-on-one to the backhand side. He loves playing right wing. He can use his left leg to shield the defenseman's stick and drive to the net. He paid that time as he crashed into the backboards. But that was vintage Glenn Anderson.
Nemchinov on with Gilbert and Kiprios. Played toward the net. Stopped by McLean. Backhands it around to Tim Hunter. Hunter is hit. Turned over the puck. Leach. He's run into, and a high stick on Gilbert from Hunter. Puck around the boards, and a hit by Bukaboom. Canucks unable to clear as Blynn is tied up with Kiprios. Battle along the boards, Demchinov works it around the other side. Lume goes for a penalty. No, I thought a penalty was going to get called. And Hunter knocked down Gilbert.
And Nick Kiprios, it looked like he almost killed himself. He missed the check, he went head first into the boards. The Rangers, you sense, really want the third goal.
Lowe looks up. Zuboff takes the pass. 4.5 minutes gone by in the second period. Down the boards. Messier was hip-checked by Brown and lost his stick. But there's a penalty coming up. Penalty coming up on the Vancouver Canucks.
Jeff Bukaboom, by the way, is over at the Rangers bench, and he may have injured himself. He tried to pinch on the near boards, and one of the Canucks ducked down, and he may have hurt himself. It looks like a leg injury or something. Messier interfered, as you see, there by Brown, the defenseman. Took a stick away and everything. Ron Smith has had enough. This will be the second power play for the Rangers. Vancouver is yet to have one in this game. Bukaboom pinched earlier. Now watch the Vancouver player duck. Oh, you can see the legs, both knees buckle. Look at the knees of Bukaboom. Oh, man, the right one may have hyperextended on the play. And Bukaboom could very well have a problem. He is still having attention paid to him on the bench. Kiprios missed the check. Look at this. Oh, man. He got up and was okay. He wears extra big shoulder pads, and they may have helped him on that play.
Antoski was the man who hit Bukaboom. Brown's in the penalty box for interference at 4:38. Rangers' second power play of the game. They're 1-for-1. And 5-for-26 in this series. Zuboff controlling. Swings it around the boards. Messier, Graves, and Kovalov with Zuboff and Leach for the Rangers. Lume with Blynn, Craven, and Bure. Craven to Bure. Zuboff goes over. Bure holding. Force
penalty.
Back out. Penalty coming.
But Bure had the puck. Craven drove to the net. And he drew a penalty. The Rangers want the puck here quickly.
They don't get it. It's going to be a break for Trevor Linden. He moves to the net. And he scores. What an effort by Trevor Linden. He was the man who came on when Kirk McLean went to the bench, the extra skater on the delayed penalty, and the Canucks have scored to cut the Rangers' lead to 2-1.
We have a huge swing here. Remember, Bukaboom may be injured. He now is going to the Rangers' locker room. It's a huge swing in the last minute or so. Bukaboom could have a leg injury. Vancouver, on the delayed penalty to the Rangers, kept control of the puck. And then you're going to see Trevor Linden come off the bench as McLean gets there, and now he reaches for the puck. He reached to the Vancouver side of center ice to make sure it was not offside. And then he scored on a beautiful play, a great shot. We're 2-1. And the Rangers still have the power play.
14:39 remaining in the second period. It's a 2-1 game. Rangers still on the power play, as John mentioned. A minute 10 to go on the penalty to Jeff Brown. Zubov has the puck. Cross comes Komolov. Graves down the boards for Komolov. Try to put it in front. Slides out to Zubov. Across the Leach with room. Back to Zubov. Takes the shot. Deflected into the corner. Messier to Leach. Across to Zubov. Down the boards. Pass Komolov. Graves ties up Lume behind the net. It's driven up the boards. Kept in by Zubov. Komolov missed it. Hedekin clears it. The Vancouver goal, Trevor Linden, his 11th of the playoffs, from Glynn and Bure at 5:21. Craven pulled down Messier, prompting the roar from the crowd. Craven takes the shot, deflects up into the crowd, stopping play. 13:42 to go. You hear the crowd reaction as Messier was spun around and flung down in center ice.
Well, this power play has not looked good for the Rangers. Vancouver has scored the shorthanded goal. There's a definite hold in the neutral zone. And Terry Gregson has to make the decisions, penalties or no penalties. 21 seconds still remaining on the Brown penalty. Both the Bulls not returned from the Rangers locker room. So a real big, big, big turn. Big turn. See Komolov with the helmet off to try and breathe a little easier. It's very hot in this building.
Bure's assist gives him 31 points in the playoffs. Two behind Ryan Leach. Excuse me, make it three behind Leach, who has 34 points. Bure with 31 in the race for the lead in playoff scoring. Leach has it. Leach has the puck. The 2-1 Rangers lead. The 13:35 to go in the second. As Lidstrom fires in. Matko shoots wide. Got it off the heel of his stick. Final seconds of the Rangers power play. Tikkanen plays it across to Leach. Leach shoots. Deflected off the arm of McLean. Bounces down behind the net. Matteau up the boards for Tikkanen. Brown is back on. Teams at full strength. Shot by Lidster. Save McLean. Craven with a muff on Larmer. Tikkanen trying to keep it in. Larmer wraps up Dittick. Tikkanen shoots, deflects across. Babich after the puck. Lidster there. He shot it wide. Tikkanen plays it behind the net. Craven picks it up. 13 minutes to go in the second. Rangers leading 2-1. Game 7. The game for the Stanley Cup Championship.
Jack Bookaboom cannot come back. Lidstrom and Wells will get more ice time. Especially Lidstrom on the right side.
McTavish chasing on Brian Glynn. Glynn reverses, but he gave it away to Gilbert. Off the stick of Noonan. Back into the corner. McTavish after it. It's worked up the boards and out of the zone. Kevin Lowe takes over. Lowe plays it across to Gilbert. In the middle of Noonan. Noonan moves it with McTavish. McTavish takes the shot. Save McLean at his feet. Ronning works his way around the net. Ronning circles back. Messier has come on. Jerky Lume moves away with help from a pick by Ronning, but gave up the puck to Kevin Lowe. Ronning stops it again. The bouncer. Richter leads it. A whistle for an offside on Vancouver. 12:01 to go. Second period. The Canucks have scored a goal by Trevor Linden. The Rangers' lead is cut to 2-1.
Widow's Peak was a place of peace and quiet until a sexy new widow came to town.
I'll take that if you please.
You will not.
No!
The critics are calling Widow's Peak a light-hearted comedy with a gleeful, naughty edge, brimming with surprises.
Don't tell me you want a favor in return.
Nothing of a disgusting nature.
Two thumbs up. Four stars. A bigger, better twist than The Crying Game.
Now, what did he mean by that?
Mia Farrow, Joan Plowright, and Natasha Richardson. Widow's Peak, rated PG.
Now playing.
Care to make a little wager?
Yeah, I wouldn't mind.
You wouldn't mind. Grass or dirt, pick your fancy.
Grass.
What grass?
All right, dirt. No, grass. I want grass.
Okay, grass it is.
It's gonna be grass.
Dirt.
Grass.
Dirt.
Grass.
Like to gamble?
Dirt.
Then gamble. At Belmont Park, you can bet on long shots, favorites, exactas, triples, the pick three, the pick six, even your favorite color if you feel lucky. So come to Belmont Park and get a run for your money.
I think I lost again.
Trevor Linden has given Vancouver their only goal in the game. It's shorthanded with a penalty upcoming to Brian Leach. He makes a great play. Look at the body language leading into Brian Leach. Now he chips the puck right over Mike Richter, right through him, actually. That's a great play.
Yeah.
Sensational play by the Vancouver captain. Jeff Bukaboom has not returned, but again, he could be in a locker room having his knee taped up. They could be finding a brace to put on the knee, if that's indeed what it is. Rangers need him back.
Jeff Brown with a long drive that Richter stops. Gilbert has the puck off the stick of Nemchinov. Word, Marv Albert passed this along, that the Vancouver Canucks had a charter for the players' wives. Here's Gilbert moving in. The shot went wide. Kiprios gets to the rebound. That charter is still circling over New York. It hasn't landed yet.
Why?
I don't know. Hedekin moving down with the puck. Brett Hedekin has been a plus player in five of the six games in this series. Leach fires across. Diddick sends it back. 11-10 remaining in the second period. Linden after the puck. Moved around the boards by Richter. Lafayette trying to play it. Nemchinov on him. Kiprios moves in to try and move the puck. Back into the corner, Leach. Leach paired with Doug Lidster now. Backhands it to Nemchinov. And he fires in. Dave Babich for Vancouver as the Rangers change. Kortnov. Slowed down by Lowe. The pass across the flex to Linden. He controls. He moves in. A save. A skate save by Richter on a great shot by Trevor Linden. And an icing coming up on the Rangers. Trevor Linden, who's been pretty quiet in this series, really putting on an effort here to get his team back in with. He scored a goal and was robbed by Mike Richter on the last chance. A break in the action brought to you by Midas, who asked you to stop in for an undercar inspection. It's the Midas way, the way it should be.
Teamwork. It's the cornerstone of any championship season. It makes good teams great. It's what makes great teams dynasties. And it's beautiful to watch. MCS Fast Responsive Service and Canon Technology are a team you can count on. Nobody knows office technology as well as Canon. Nobody knows Canon as well as MCS. They work together like this. MCS Canon. One is a great reason to buy the other.
Unsatisfied with his seat, Ed sneaks onto the field to get close to the action.
Okay, now.
Three guys on the bottom stacked.
On the bottom.
Pyramid play is what I call it. I come around, but the guy on top vaults in a carnival-like way.
Oh! I'm cramping.
Whoa! Whoa! Does your mouth guard taste like banana?
That's security, right? I gotta go.
Next time, Ed should check the sports stadium map in the 9X Yellow Pages. 9X. More information, more solutions, more stuff.
Pat Quinn looking on. His Canucks have rallied back. They're within one. They put some pressure on the Rangers.
Pat Quinn has won in every league he's been involved with, except for the National Hockey League. We're talking about championships.
Crowd on its feet, and a Let's Go Rangers chant going up. Craven against Messier on the draw. Rangers control. Messier with Graves and Anderson. Leach and Lidster. Craven with Bure and Adams, Glynn and Lume. Lidster slides it out of the zone. Lume is there off the boards. Leach picks it up. It's a pick from Lidster. Graves couldn't control. Messier tried to get it. Lidster sends it in. Lume got a piece. Graves with a good hit on the boards. Craven's got the puck. Tipped out by Adams. Leach hustling back. Gets some direction from Richter. Avoids Bure. They both went down. The puck along the boards. Kept in by Hedekin. Along the boards, Adams trying to get free. He's forced back by Lidster, who takes the puck away. Tipped clear by Anderson. 9.5 minutes to go in the second. Rangers leading 2-1. Adams. Kevin Lowe comes over. Puck bounces down in the penalty box and play stops with 9:19 to go. Rangers without Jeff Bukaboom for the last couple of minutes.
After game six, in which the Rangers lost, Esa Tikkanen was one of the first players to try to lighten things up. The Rangers had a team meal right after the game. And they were pretty down with the loss. But Tikkanen, knowing his attitude and his personality, tried right there to spark the players. He's a big game player. He's a great checker. People hate playing against him. In particular, Wayne Gretzky hates playing against Esa Tikkanen. And he'd love one half more of a big game and having a good one.
Tavish reached up, trying to knock the puck down. He's got it. Sends it off the boards for Noonan. Sends it into Vancouver zone. McLean looks around, keeps it moving. Yellen and Lowe go for it.
It's been a strong line for the Rangers in this game, and they needed that. Other players to put forth a good effort. McTavish, Noonan, and Tikkanen.
Meso slides it ahead. Jelena couldn't get there. Lowe trying to clear the zone. It's in deep. Zuboff has it. Trying to get away from Jelena. Able to clear the zone. 8:35 to go in the second. Vidic. Former Meso. Zuboff is there. Now Kevin Lowe. Whistle for a two-line pass. Rangers having some problems getting in the offensive zone last couple of minutes.
Vancouver, led by their goaltender, had a strong beginning as far as keeping the puck out of their own net. The Rangers really pressed, and they couldn't score. Then, with the shorthanded goal, Vancouver has settled the Rangers' offense down. There was a hit as Momessa was knocked down.
Jeff Kukubom has just emerged from the Rangers' locker room and is heading to the bench. Seems to be walking okay. Taken back by Dittick. Chopped at by Kovalov. Dittick sends it ahead. A hit by Wells. A shot was blocked by Lidster. Bounces on goal. Stopped by Richter. Larmer pressured by Lafayette. Moves it around to Lidster. Nice pass to Kovalov. A little behind low. Able to get it out of the zone. Babich forces his way back in, surrounded by Rangers. The other way comes Matteau with Dittick back. Matteau the backhand, wide. Wells gets to the puck, shot it wide of the net. Knocked away from Kovalov by Babich. Matteau goes over, gets it to Lidster, takes the shot wide. Around the boards, Wells and Lafayette. Wells takes it away. Deep into the corner, Babich gets it up the boards. Lidster pinches, Kovalov has the puck, and the shot goes wide. Rangers have missed the net three times. Matteau. Kovalov takes the shot just wide again. Kovalov taken down by Linden. Kovalov bumped by Dittick and tripped up by Dittick, and a penalty call.
Porto. He picked up and knocked down Jeff Larmer. The Rangers with a great shift. Matteau, Kovalov, and Larmer. Yes, they missed the net three times, but they got the puck back every time. And they worked. And then finally, Courtnell and Babich ended up hauling people down. And you're right, it is Babich, not Courtnell. Watch the Rangers battle to get the puck back. Look at Matteau not quit. Larmer's there. In front is Babich. Rangers miss the net, but get the puck back. Kovalov battles. Goes right through Dittick, and there you see Courtnell dropping down with Larmer.
I thought it was Dittick who took the penalty.
I thought it was Courtnell.
It's Babich for tripping at 12:46. In any event, the Rangers have the power play, their third of the game.
It's one of the best games I've seen Alexei Kovalov play as a Ranger, even though he hasn't scored a goal. He is just working. He's thinking. He's giving it everything he's got. He's taking hits to make plays, and he didn't do that in Vancouver.
And that's what the Rangers need. They're to win a championship. Their third power play, they're one for two.
And Vancouver has a shorthanded goal.
Messier played across. Zuboff has it. In deep to Noonan. I don't know if that's credited as a shorthanded goal shot. Shot by Graves is a save by McLean because it was 5-on-5 when Linden came on as the extra skater on it.
McLean
penalty.
Was on the bench.
Yeah, but you had five skaters on.
Doesn't matter.
All right. Yeah. All right.
Rangers had six with Richter.
Okay. A hit in the corner. Rangers have Graves, Messier, and Noonan for the power play. Zuboff and Leach. Noonan turns, puts it in front. Missed by Graves. Noonan's backhander save, and they score! Messier! It's a power play goal! Delivered. scores again.
Just hard work once again. Zubac with the play to the front, Noonan to the front, Messier, and the puck is chipped in behind Kirk McLean. Adam Graves is there, Noonan's there, and I think Noonan will get credit as the defenseman in front put it in his own net. You'll see, actually it's McIntyre, the forward. He gets his hand on it, and it goes right through the legs of Kirk McLean. So Brian Noonan may get credit for the goal. The Rangers have drawn two power plays that have led to power play goals because of hard work in behind the goal line, and that was their game plan.
6:15 to go in the second. The Rangers have regained a two-goal lead. Keeping it with the puck. Messier gets credit for the goal. Marmer sets up Tikkanen. His shot deflected by Brown. Adams back for the puck. Adams checked by McTavish. Hennigan has the puck for Vancouver. Rangers have outshot the Canucks 25-15 and lead 3-1, and they have scored two power play goals. Bure was stopped by Leach. Bure knocks the puck down. Leach has the stick in the midsection. Tipped ahead. Richter covers up with Adams there. They're on their feet at Madison Square Garden. There's 5:37 remaining in the second period, and the Rangers lead 3-1.
I'm going camping this weekend. Man, I love it.
And I hate camping.
I want to sleep on dirt. I wouldn't vacuum.
Fresh air, birds, trees,
snakes, bears. Poison ivy.
It's funny how two people can look at the same thing differently.
You stand in the clean, clear water and catch your own dinner.
Well, you stand in the freezing cold water and catch pneumonia.
To some, this is a great-tasting imported beer. And to others, it's a great-tasting light beer. Either way, it's Amstel Light.
It's beautiful. You're out there in the middle of nowhere.
It stinks. You're out there in the middle of nowhere.
Nobody beats the Wiz Price Patrol Exhibit A. 10 cassettes purchased from a national music chain, $109.90. The same 10 cassettes at Nobody Beats the Wiz, $79.80. 10 CDs from a national music chain, $173.90. The same 10 CDs at Nobody Beats the Wiz, $119.80. Beginning to notice a trend? At Nobody Beats the Wiz, we shop, you save. Our price is right every day.
Jeff Bukerbohm on the bench has not had a shift since returning from the locker room. We'll watch to see. He comes back on the ice, went off after he was pinched along the board. Seemed to have a leg problem. 5:37 to go. They love it at Madison Square Garden. Rangers leading 3-1.
They have not been outworked in this game. Everybody is doing something. Kovalov, Matteau, Larmer, Noonan. Everybody.
McTavish has had a strong game. Tipped ahead. Taken and goes back to get it. Tikkanen, McTavish, and Noonan on. Messier got the goal, his 12th of the playoffs, from Graves and Noonan at 13:29. The Rangers with two power play goals. Bemeso threw the elbow into Zubov, running with a setup for Gelinas just behind him. Gelinas left it along the boards. In deep running, comes out in front. Puck is loose, knocked aside. Didn't shoot. Save, Richter. Zubov can't clear. Save, Richter on running. And another save. And he's got the puck.
Oh, did Sergei Zubov ever get nailed by Sergio Bemeso right up at center ice along the boards? And that gave Vancouver a chance to move in. Watch this hit. Boom. Zubov didn't know what number the train was. And now Vancouver has a chance to throw the puck at the net, and it's Mike Richter's turn. This save on Ronning was spectacular. Absolutely spectacular. He'll drop down, watch him stack the pads. Oh, my, what a save. As Cliff Ronning was robbed, Vancouver tries everything they can. Started with a big hit by Bemeso, and Mike Richter, oh, doesn't get any better.
Chit-chat. Now, what could Alexei Kovalov be telling Mike Richter?
Hey, whatever it is, it's working for Kovalov. He's played brilliantly.
Actually, he's probably discussed the face-off. Matteau and Larmer, two-on-one. Saved by McLean. Matteau centers. Puck moved aside. Lynch dribbles it down the boards. Kovalov in the corner. Lume to the puck. 4.5 minutes to go. Second period. Rangers leading 3-1. Kovalov for Marner. The end of the Vancouver zone they go. Lume back to get it. Marner forechecking. Now it's Brian Glenn. Stopped by Kovalov in center. He's bumped by Glenn. Lafayette works it ahead. Lidster stops Courtnall, and Wells takes the puck. Fired across and out of the zone. Linden has to clear out. The next trying to get onside. Linden doing some punching and shoving with Marner. Lidster gets to the red line. It's knocked down by Jeff Brown, picked up by Graves. Graves looks. He's passing off a skate of Hedekin. Out comes Murray Craven. Pass behind Borre, sent away by Zubov. Glenn Anderson. He's stopped by Adams, trying to hit Borre. Zubov gets it to Messier with 3:35 to go in the second. McLean leaves it for Brown. Around the boards, Leach has it. Pass to Anderson. Hedekin checked by Messier. Graves along the board.
Messier got a hooking call. This is a chance for Vancouver to get back in the game regarding the score. Messier reached out and with a little tug pulled down one of the Canuck players. And now a very important 2 minutes ahead for the Rangers. It's 3:21 on the clock. One of the better penalty killers, the best face-off man for the Rangers, goes to the box. Not much of a tug. Watch this.
Helped out by Hedekin.
Oh, yeah.
He helped it out.
Absolutely.
Threw it nicely. He made the play he had to make. Messier shaking his head. Hooking at 16:39 gives Vancouver their first power play of the game. They are only 2-for-33 in the series. And Jeff Fukuboom set for his first shift since coming out of the locker room.
Very interesting that he'll be used to kill penalties and toughness in front of the net. Now he goes back off. I don't think he can, Sam.
Okay, tested
sure. Now, Vancouver's power play. Linden has one goal, one assist. Brown has one goal, one assist on the two goals Vancouver has scored. And there you see Pat Quinn and Ron Smith trying to get their strategy together. Jeff Fukuboom is just too sore. You know he'd try if he could. So Leach and Lidster now have to start the penalty kill.
Tikkanen, Larmer, Lidster, and Leach for the Rangers. Linden, Ronning, Borre, Brown, and Courtnall for Vancouver. Borre is playing the right point. Jeff Brown with the puck. Courtnall sends in. Leach to the puck, drives it up the boards. Knocked down by Borre. Good play. Tikkanen trying to take it away from Linden. Crowd along the boards. Linden with a good effort to keep it in. Ronning pushes it ahead. Leach gets to the puck and he clears. Up the boards. Cleared by Tikkanen. 2:50 to go in the second. 3-1. Rangers leading it. Larmer on Borre. Ronning turns with a puck. Met by Tikkanen. Borre. Forced back by Tikkanen. Now it's Ronning. And the chant of defense goes up from the crowd as Tikkanen takes the puck. Linden was taken down by Leach, and Tikkanen waits and then clears.
Great shift by Tikkanen, Lidster, and Leach. And they now all change. Fresh bodies on the ice for the Rangers.
Graves, McTavish, Lowen, Zubov for the Rangers. Brown slides it to Greg Adams. Adams moves in, met by Zubov. McTavish helps out. Lamessa with a cross check on Graves, knocked him down. McTavish moves it around, Borre in to play it. Borre to Ronning, keeps it moving to Lamessa. Adams chases after it. He was tugged down by Zubov. Zubov trying to work it loose. Adams plays it up the boards for Ronning. Back for Brown. Graves steps in, and he clears. 30 seconds to go on the Vancouver power play. They have not had a shot on goal yet. Matteau hooking at Borre. Borre stayed on for the full power play. Matteau drives it down the ice, but it deflected into the Vancouver bench.
So the faceoff will be inside the Rangers zone. Borre has great stamina, but he has not been able to find a way to get quality scoring chances in this game. Again, he's had more shots than any other player in the playoffs. He had 19 shots in the last three games going into this one. Esa Tikkanen is starting to drive people nuts. Watch this on Jeff Brown. Watch where the sticks go. Look at Jeff Brown's stick. Through the legs. Tikkanen, now watch him talk to Brown. Think about a slash. Now he's trying to bait Brown. Then all of a sudden, a little tug, and there goes Brown's stick. That's Esa Tikkanen at his best. He'd drive anybody crazy.
15 seconds to go in Messier's penalty. 1:41 to go in the second. Following the second, Al Trautwig with Emil Francis. Cat chat between periods. Bob Page with an update at the MSG Sports Desk. JD and I will look at highlights. Don't go away. A little work by Kevin Collins on the end of the stick. Craig McTavish. McTavish on the faceoff against Murray Craven. Craven, Momesso, and Adams, Babbage, and Lume. Gorey has gone off. Lidster moves it up the boards. Lume keeps it in. Chased by Lidster. Momesso is there to play it. Now Craven moves it behind the net. Adams wraparound try. Saved by Richter. Into the corner it goes, and Weimer clears all the way down. Power play is over for Vancouver. Teams at full strength. Rangers lead 3-1 with a minute 15 to go in the second. Lidster's got the puck. Messier chasing against Didick. Messier with a hit, trying to get loose to take it away. He's hit, and Kovalov hits back. Puck moved out by Babbage. Craven dumps it ahead. Less than a minute to go in the second period. Momesso on low. Zubov takes a hard hit from Antoski. Matteau gets it to Messier. Kovalov racing forward. Kovalov is in. The backhander's wide. Kovalov chases down against McIntyre. Puck loose. Leek steps up to keep it in the zone. Hunter gets it ahead to Antoski. Antoski sends it in. Leek back to the puck. 30 seconds to go in the period. Each team with a goal here in the second. Take it away. Nice setup for Courtois. Save Richter. Quinn couldn't play it. McTavish has the puck. 20 seconds in the period. McTavish controls. McLean holds the puck. Courtnall pressed by Noonan. Hunter winds up, deflected into the corner. Final seconds of the second period. Standing ovation. The Rangers are 20 minutes away.
Vancouver does what they do best. Towards the end of the period, they use the body. They try to punish the Rangers. Remember, they don't have Bukaboom on the blue line. Rangers' penalty killing was fabulous, and they needed that. Alexei Kovalov with a hug from Kiprios. Alexei Kovalov has played the game of his life, as have many, many New York Rangers. They have the 3-1 lead, and now they have to just make sure they have composure during the intermission, because Vancouver, with their brilliance, watch them come back. They'll try.
Rangers lead 3-1. That's the score in Times Square.
The Yanks are in Camden Yards to battle the Orioles again Wednesday night on MSG.
Shaquille O'Neal starts his lineup with one of his funk dunks on Alonzo Mourning. The fans brace for a tremor. There's a loud whack. The fans open their eyes, then their mouths. The backboard's still there. Shaq's on the floor, and the score hasn't changed. Alonzo Mourning had pinned the ball against Shaq's palm and the 4-cent Shaq on his wallet. Then Mourning turns to Shaq and shows the same menacing glare that kid gave Shaq in the soda commercial.
The word is out. Coliseum Mall is the choice for savings and selection. Find the cheapest prices on clothing, leather, electronics, and cosmetics. Over 100 shops offer quality merchandise at the lowest prices anywhere. The cheapest prices on sneakers, shoes, records, and much more. Visit the home of Queen's largest jewelry exchange. Coliseum Mall, open Monday through Saturday, 11 a.m. to 7 p.m. with plenty of rooftop parking.
So I'm in the market for new kitchen appliances. One dealer tells me to forget about it. Forget about what? The selection? The savings? The service? Hey, I work hard for my money. When I buy a product, I want a company that stands behind it. At PC Richard, you remember 84 years of honesty, integrity, reliability, and service. And you get the lowest prices, too. Guaranteed. I won't forget about it. I need PC Richard.
It's here. All the heroics and the heartbreaks of the 1994 Stanley Cup playoffs are now available on video cassette. This official NHL production is filled with non-stop action from the opening face-off to the victory skate with hockey's ultimate prize. Only $19.94 plus $4 shipping. Call this toll-free number to order your Stanley Cup Collector's Edition. Order today.
The amount of time needed, the amount of time remaining continues to shrink. We are down to 20 minutes, and the Rangers have to protect a two-goal lead in order to win the Stanley Cup. Al Trautwig with Emil the Cat Francis. And Emil, it was a two-goal lead that the Rangers built up in the first period, and now they've regained with their second power play goal of the game. But again, it's been their best players who have risen to the occasion and scored. And we talked before this game about Adam Graves solving his 10-game drought, and he did.
He sure did. And, you know, for the Rangers to win, you knew he had a score, and they came right out firing. They're playing a good control game. And right off the bat, you know, you could see him forechecking and containing the Vancouver club in their end. When you do that, it's going to pay off with opportunities and goals.
All right, here's the first goal of the game. It's, again, the big players. Leach out for Messier.
Beautiful play by Messier. He stops, turns, he sees he's got nowhere to go, passes the puck off here to Zubov. Zubov takes a look, gives it over to Brian Leach, and here's Leach with an awning net, takes his time and puts it right in. He made sure of that one.
And look at the man who was in front creating the problems for Kirk McLean. That was Adam Graves. And boy, when he was open in the slot, everyone gasped.
Well, you know, that's what he had to do. Now, here he comes back again. The puck comes over to Graves. He takes a look and beats him on the stick side, which is a good place to go into goalkeeper.
Now, as the Rangers look forward to the third period, they know that Mike Richter is also on top of his game. Watch Cliff Ronning with the chance here.
Tremendous save. The puck comes across. Ronning, who's been a thorn in the side all the way along, picks it up all by himself. Mike Richter, he can move across so quickly, which he just did there, and comes up with a big save and held the score at 3-1.
All right, Emil will be back with Bob Page as we continue our coverage as this game moves along. But Bob Page will update you on the world of sports all by himself when we come back on MSG with the Rangers up 3-1.
In Canada, they learn to play hockey before they learn to walk. So it's no wonder Bill Christian exports his hockey sticks from the U.S. to Canada. And it's no wonder he chooses AT&T. They give him discounts to every phone in Canada, not just two of them. That's his AT&T business advantage. And it's turned Bill into an all-star stick handler.
AT&T works for me.
Let's talk business. You have your office. I have mine. You want to win, you got to have the right players.
The right shop copier can boost productivity
and save you money. Whether it's the most reliable high-volume copier ever tested,
a modular system you can grow with, or the convenience of a compact, call for Shop's new winning game plan video. It'll help you pick the right shop copier. That's what it takes to win it all.
With an available 220 V8, full-time four-wheel drive, standard four-wheel anti-lock brakes, and driver's side airbag, Jeep Grand Cherokee is fully equipped to handle life in the wild. Of course, it's also quite comfortable in more civilized surroundings. Now get special values on select Grand Cherokees.
There's only one Jeep, and it's only at your Tri-State Jeep and Eagle dealers.
The Privilege Plus card at Nobody Beats the Wiz. You pay 0% interest for 90 days. 0%. Nobody beats the Wiz.
Try to keep things clean.
Why?
Because I said so.
When you fill up with Mobile Super Plus detergent gasoline,
don't bounce the ball off the ceiling.
You put years of detergent know-how into your engine.
I just washed the windows. Keep your fingers off the glass. This thing looks worse than your room does.
So we can help you clean the inside of your engine as you drive. Keep vital parts free from dirt and deposits. Of course, keeping the inside of your car clean, well, we'll have to leave that up to you. Mobile, how can we help you?
New York Rangers Hockey is brought to you in part by Hertz. For business, for pleasure, nobody does it exactly like Hertz. And by Mobile, helping you clean your engine with Mobile Super Plus detergent gasoline.
Hi, everybody. Bob Page back in our Sports Desk studios once again. The latest round of musical chairs of the NHL offseason apparently is continuing. Now the Flyers have scheduled an afternoon news conference for tomorrow, at which time they are expected to bring back their former captain, Bobby Clarke, and announce that he is returning from his stint in Florida to take over in some as yet to be determined or at least announced front office capacity. Now in baseball at Baltimore, the Yankees trailing the Orioles 3-2 as they play in the bottom of the seventh inning. Dennis Mulholland, Terry Mulholland's been on the pitching mound tonight for the Yankees. Chris Hoyle's bloop single in the fifth inning off Mulholland makes it 3-1. Hasn't Mulholland been awful? Three straight losses he's had, ERA 7.29 during that period. Ex-Yankee Bobby Munoz got the start for the Phillies tonight against Doc Gooden out at Shea. And Philadelphia leads the Mets 3-1 now. They are playing here in the late stages of the game. Doc Gooden K'd 10 in a seven-inning stint. He led 1-0 going into the frame, but Kim Batiste delivers an RBI single to make it 2-1 for Philadelphia. John Crockett hit a solo homer a few moments earlier. Roger Mason came on to relieve Gooden to start the eighth inning. I'll be back right after these messages.
The same mind that created a child's first camera created a professional camera with the world's fastest shutter speed. The same mind that gives you a close look at the moon lets you zoom close to a star. The same mind that perfected autofocus in photography introduced autofocus to binoculars. All this visual technology at your fingertips could only come from one mind. Only from the mind of Minolta.
Picture yourself 20 years from now. Will you be comfortable? Happy? Chase can help. We make available a wide range of investment alternatives, including the Vista family of mutual funds. Call today. So when it's time to stop and smell the roses, you can enjoy the whole garden. Stop by or call 1-800-AT-CHASE. Chase Manhattan.
A veritable must game facing the Knicks at the Garden tomorrow night, providing the Garden is still standing should the Rangers hang on and win. Much as Adam Graves needed to get going for the Rangers to do anything, the Knicks have got to get something out of Charles Oakley if they expect to beat Houston.
When he rolled his ankle in Indianapolis, he has been hobbled since then and really playing hurt. So it has hurt his effectiveness and his all-out, reckless, abandoned play. He's been one of our great helpers. His helps are down a little bit, so I'm concerned about it.
You can tell it a little bit because when he get like long rebounds, you can see him favor one of the ankles, and hopefully, you know, he can keep favoring ankle until we win this thing.
Don't forget our post-game show, as now the Rangers are 20 minutes away from winning the Stanley Cup at long last, an eventful third period after, again, this timeout.
You wouldn't buy a new car without driving it first. Our 33-day test drive offers you the same opportunity. Nobody beats the whiz.
Care to make a little wager?
Yeah, I wouldn't mind.
Okay, spit or bubble, make your call.
Bubble. Definitely bubble.
Bubble?
It's gonna be bubble.
Going spit, pal. He's a spit man.
No way.
He's a spit man.
No way.
Spit.
Bubble.
Come on, baby. Bit.
Like to gamble? Then gamble. At Belmont Park, you can bet on long shots, favorites, exactas, triples, the pick three, the pick six, even your favorite color if you feel lucky. So come to Belmont Park and get a run for your money.
I think I lost again.
This weekend, experience the phenomenon of the motion picture event of the year. Brandon Lee, The Crow, rated R.
Welcome back to Madison Square Garden. The Rangers have a 3-1 lead. We'll take a look at second period highlights brought to you by Minolta, makers of the new Freedom 105EX, only from the mind of Minolta. Trevor Linden comes off the bench and gets the goal, John.
It was a delayed penalty against the Rangers, and Linden got the puck right at center ice, and the puck doesn't want to settle down for him. He leans into Brian Leetch, and then he just off the toe of the blade of his stick chips the puck, and it finds a way through Mike Richter. That's a brilliant play by the Vancouver captain that got them back in the game, a shorthanded goal.
Rangers on the power play again.
Well, Brian Noonan has good hands, and you'll find him after putting the puck towards Adam Graves, find the puck again. Now he'll put it on goal, and watch the hand right there of McIntyre. The puck is put back through the legs of Kirk McLean. The Rangers needed the goal. It gave them the two-goal lead once again.
And then Mike Richter standing up big against Cliff Ronning.
A couple of times in this game, the Canucks have had flurries, and this is one of them. Look at over on the side. Ronning shot the puck quickly. But feet first went Mike Richter, and he doesn't do that often unless he has no choice. Richter read the play. Beautiful save as he robbed Ronning.
We'll be back with a third period right after this.
Hey, it's time to get live on Prodigy. We're at Madison Square Garden in New York. Game 7 of the Stanley Cup Finals between the Rangers and the Canucks with everything on the line. With me is the New York Rangers all-time leading scorer, Rod Gilbert. Rod, what are your thoughts on tonight's matchup?
Well, this is what I think. No one wants the Stanley Cup more than the Rangers and their fans. So I'm convinced that they'll find a way to win this.
Now, all week long, Rod, on Prodigy's bulletin board, you've been answering questions about Vancouver's chances.
Well, you know how Prodigy members are. Hockey fans don't get any tougher than that. But no matter how much we argue back and forth, they can't convince me that the Rangers and my heart are going to win it.
I know someone who agrees with you, Rangers phenomenon Brian Leetch. And later tonight, Brian will be answering a bunch of members' questions.
And don't forget to look for my answers to your latest questions, too.
If you're not a member, call 1-800-979-LIVE for Prodigy Software, plus 1 month's membership free.
Here, summer sports from the New York Lottery. Six new games, six ways to win up to $5,000 instantly. They're the hottest tickets in town.
This program is authorized by Madison Square Garden Productions Incorporated, solely for the entertainment of our audience. And any publication, rebroadcast, or other use of the pictures, descriptions, and accounts of this event without the express written consent of Madison Square Garden Productions Incorporated is prohibited. New York Rangers hockey is brought to you in part by Nobody Beats the Wiz. For state-of-the-art home electronics, computers, cameras, music, movies, and more, nobody beats the Wiz. And by Modell's. Gotta go to Mo's.
Back at the Garden, where Ranger fans are about to experience the longest 20 minutes of their lives. Back with a couple of other members of the Ranger alumni here, Dave Maloney and Elf Nielsen. You guys must be having a ball watching in the front row in the penalty box.
It's great. This city has been so great to me and Anders when we came 79 here, and I'm really happy for all the fans the way it's going right now.
Dave, I spoke to Ron Duguay before about, you know, the good-spirited jealousy that one would feel to be on the ice to play in a game like this. How about it?
Well, I don't think it's jealousy. I think it's just competitive instinct. It's what makes us all the players we hopefully were at one time. Mm-hmm. But I think from my standpoint, I think I speak for a lot of us, the Rangers have been wonderful to us old guys. Mm-hmm. And this is just a terrific deal. I really feel that we all had a part of this in some infamous or famous way. And it's really just terrific stuff. It just really doesn't get any better than this. And it's just been wonderful. And the Rangers have been terrific.
Are you nervous, Elf?
Well, I'm nervous for the Ranger fans. I can't really get into it myself that much, but I really feel that the city needs this win, and I think it's great, but I'm not getting too excited about it.
All right, so from this perspective, it looks as though winning tonight for the Rangers would be a public service. Let's get ready for the third period. Sam and J.D.
Thanks, Al. Ulf Nielsen, Dave Maloney. Second period scoring summary is brought to you by Mitsubishi, the new thinking in automobiles. Trevor Linden's 11th of the playoffs, a shorthanded goal, made it 2-1. Messier's power play goal still stands, could have been credited to Brian Noonan. Noonan and Graves assisting, shots on goal, Rangers 14, total 26, Canucks 12, total 21. Rangers are 2-for-3 on the power play, and the Canucks are 0-for-1. And we are set for the third period, this most dramatic moment approaching, as the Rangers take a 3-1 lead into this third period of Game 7.
Mike Keenan, prior to the game, said he wanted his team to work as a team with confidence and enthusiasm like they have all season long. Well, he's certainly seen that. And to this point, Pavel Bure has only had one shot on goal through two periods. The big boys are back on the ice to start the period for Vancouver, and they may really try to be enthusiastic with their body work.
No Jeff Fookaboom. He has not returned to the ice. So the Rangers will be without him for this third period. Messier, Anderson, and Graves. Leach and Lidster for the Rangers. McClain leaves it for Babbage. Around the boards, Tim Hunter. Hunter, McIntyre, and Antoski for Vancouver. Lidster ridden hard by Antoski. Leach moves it. Graves is hit by Diddick. And Vancouver coming out, banging.
You knew it was going to happen.
Fired across the boards. Anderson brings it out. Anderson chased by Antoski. Anderson moves in. One hands it in front. Tipped wide by Graves. Around the boards. Hunter moves it out of the zone.
Right, if Dougie Lidster ever get nailed by Antoski, appears to be all right, but Vancouver wanted that on the first shift. It's like going after a wounded animal. Without Bookaboom, the Rangers are hurting on the blue line, and Vancouver tries to take advantage of it.
Bore is wrapped up by Matteau as the Rangers press. Larmer sneaks free with a puck that Hedekin steps in front of him to take it. He's forced back by Matteau. 1 minute gone by in the third. Matteau checked by, Hedekin checked by Larmer, knocked it away, and it's kept in by Komolov. Matteau races to the puck, sets up Larmer with tip. Great play by Jeff Brown diving across. Back the other way. It's got in by Adams, by Greg Adams. Zubov takes over. Moves away with the puck. Two players went down, Adams and Lowe. Deep in the Rangers zone. Yerke Lume fires ahead. Wide of the net. After the puck comes Glenn. It's knocked away from him. Komolov has it. Leach trying to keep it moving. Brian Glenn goes over to play it. In deep. Greg Adams. Blocked by Glenn, who knocks it away. It's kept in by Trevor Linden. His shot into the chest of Richter. He drops it off for Leach. Linden forechecking, off the boards, out of the zone. Nice play by Komolov and pushed it ahead. Lume is bumped by Noonan. 2 minutes gone by in the third period. Jeff Cortinol is chased by Craig McTavish. Stopped by Tikkanen. It slid across. Leach goes over to play it. Diddick on him. McTavish sends in from the red line. Rangers holding a 3-1 lead as David Babbage moves up. Lead for Lafayette is too long. This will be an icing. The fans love it at the Garden. The Rangers have a 2-goal lead. Anthony Mason, he's a Ranger fan. 17:35 to go.
It's a round world, genuine and true.
Every year, one credit card gives you something other credit cards don't. Only the Discover card offers you a cashback bonus award. Cash. Over $400 million paid so far. And there's no annual fee. So use the Discover card and improve your cash flow. It pays to Discover, the card that pays you back.
Tomorrow night at the Garden, another big game. As this great stretch of games continues, Anthony Mason, when did you become a hockey fan?
Well, I went to a few games last year, and I got into it. You know, I started trying to learn a little different things about the game. And then the better the team became, the more following, and I started looking at the game more. And this year, I've really been up for it.
Thanks, Mace. You know he loves the hitting, Sam and J.D.
Thanks, Al. Good luck to Anthony Mason and the Knicks tomorrow night. Jay Wells shoots. Save made by Kirk McClain. Backhands it up the board. Wells pinching in. Linden trying to take it away. McTavish goes for the puck. McTavish to Noonan. Noonan cuts in. Noonan shoots. Save McClain. The rebound loose. Noonan tied up. And the puck cleared aside. Lidster chips it ahead. Once again, this line of McTavish and Noonan. And Tikkanen doing an excellent job of keeping Vancouver pinned. Here's Noonan to the net. Poke checked away. And it's stopped by McClain on the goal line.
A brilliant shift. And the Rangers again needed something like that. McTavish now wrestled from behind by Gerald Diddick. Brian Noonan and Stefan Matteau and Craig McTavish, amongst others, have really risen for this game. At times, you wondered, was Brian Noonan hurt worse than we thought? He had a subluxed shoulder during the Devils series. He had a bad leg. And look at Kirk McLean with a goal stick make the save and then find a way. Oh, baby. He reaches back and captures the puck. Smart save. Noonan was actually in too deep here. He's reaching. He's at the end of a shift. And the aggressive goal stick by McLean keeps the puck away. Look at Brian Noonan make the move outside, inside of Gerald Dinnan. And then he'll go to try and find the rebound, but he can't get there. Dave Babich's big feeder in the way. And Noonan goes to the bench after a terrific shift.
I like those medical terms you use, John. The sublux shoulder, that's good. You've been learning the medical stuff. You're not nervous, are you? Zubov moving with a puck. Knocked away by Zelina. Here's Graves. Bumped by Mameso. Graves moving in deep. He's checked by Hedekin. Now Messier. Stopped by McLean. Zelina for Mameso. 16:45 to go in the third period. Zelina in the corner against Zubov. Anderson trying to find the puck. Zelina moves it. Side of the net. There's Kevin Lowe. Out to Messier. Messier dumps it in. 3.5 minutes gone by in the third. Rangers leading 3-1. Jeff Brown. Hedekin fires out. Good play by Lidster. Again, Lidster stepped up. Komolov chipping it ahead. Got knocked down by Zelina. The puck cleared out of the zone. Komolov is there to play it. Pushed his way by Ronning and sent it into Vancouver zone. 4 minutes gone by in the third. Lidster stops it, sends it in. Rangers get onside, go for a change. Jeff Brown has the puck. Adams trips it ahead. Here's Dory breaking in. He's pulled down and a penalty called on Tikkanen.
He's like a shark, an absolute shark. And now all of a sudden it gets quiet in Madison Square Garden. A shark is Bore. He was in, he was home free, and Tikkanen reached out, pulled him down. You turned that a good penalty, I think, knowing it was Bore on the puck and he was in home free. You see the puck get chipped ahead by Greg Adams, and Tikkanen has trouble with it. Now, Bore would have been in from the top of the circle on Mike Richter, who was caught moving out, I think. Maybe not set. Oh, he was set. Anyway, Bore was dragged down. It's a very, very, very important 2 minutes ahead for both teams. There's the shark. He's only had one shot. Tried to get a second and was dragged down.
Tikkanen for hooking at 4:16. Gets the Canucks their second power play of the game. They are 0-1.
Even though Tikkanen's a penalty killer, the Rangers use 9 different forwards to kill penalties. So they've got plenty of reserve in that area.
Jeff Lucabum has returned to the Rangers bench. Tandem defense goes up. Messier won the draw. Leach with the clear. Canucks with Brown and Bore at the points. Cortnall, Linden, and Ronning up front. This is Jeff Brown with the puck. Around the boards. Leach and Lidster with Messier and Graves for the Rangers. Messier and Leach are there. Leach trying to lift it clear. Taken away by Ronning. Ronning around the net. Ronning back pass. Brown couldn't tee up a shot. Ronning to Cortnall. He shot it. They score! As it was batted in by Trevor Linden.
That's a beautiful goal. As far as pass work and power play goals go, this was an absolute beauty. Now it's 3-2.
It's a one-goal game again. The Canucks have been down by 2 twice.
The Canucks have 4 players on that side, only 2 Rangers, and they control the puck. Now you're going to see 2 great passes. This one and this one. And then Trevor Linden gets his second goal, his second specialty team's goal of the game. Linden's in front, he'll get open, and Mike Richter, he just can't get across. He tried desperately, and Linden shot the puck quickly and accurately. And hang on.
I don't expect Cortnall to shoot. A brilliant pass by Jeff Cortnall. Linden's second of the game, a shorthanded goal, a power play goal, and it's a 3-2 game with 15:05 to go in the third period. Rangers are offside on the play. 15:01 on the clock. Linden gets the goal, his 12th of the playoffs, from Cortnall and Ronning at 4:50 to cut the Rangers' lead to 1.
It's Macy's one-day sale with special hours 8 a.m. to 11 p.m. For dad, wrinkle-free cotton walking shorts, $19.99. Seiko Citizen and Pulsar, 25 to 50%, plus an extra 10% off. Sony 32-inch stereo TV, now just $999. For women, linen cotton shorts, $14.99. Sandals, espadrilles, and sneakers, 25 to 30% off. Spectacular savings and values in every department. Macy's one-day sale, Wednesday.
This summer, the best thrillers aren't just at the movies. Read Striptease by Carl Hyacin. Funny, bawdy, and outrageous. A New York Times bestseller. Striptease.
Switch to WCBS News Radio 88.
Later, Mom.
Afternoon thunderstorms.
Take your raincoat. WCBS News Radio is my survival kit.
WCBS News Radio 88. All news, all day, all night.
Well, I don't know about that, but certainly the Rangers want it now. They're up 3-2, but the Canucks, they continue to come back. What heart they've shown throughout the playoffs. They did it against Calgary. They've done it in this series, and they continue to fight back against the Rangers. Down by 2 goals twice. They are back within one. Cortnall in center. Lead for Nathan Lafayette. Moving in on Zuboff. He shoots. Save Richter. And McTavish got to the rebound. Another big save by Mike Richter. Keeking in the other way. Drops it off for Zuboff. Zuboff moves in deep. Around to McTavish. He's double teamed. Noonan in the corner. Tries to get it to McTavish. He's hit by Brian Glenn. McTavish keeps it alive. Keeking looking for it. And a whistle stops play, 14:21 to go.
Trevor Linden with a second goal here in the third period. He scored the majority of his goals in third periods this season, so he gets a big one. However, it was Lafayette, one-on-one, goes to the outside of Zuboff and gets a good shot. He caught Richter moving, and that's why Richter went down on the original shot. He was moving and off balance. See him moving to his left? Now he kicks out the right foot, and McTavish kicked out his right foot to drag the puck away, so the rebound wasn't there for a Canuck player to dart in.
Shots are 30-24 in favor of the Rangers, who lead 3-2. Leach, Graves, and Messier, the goal scorers for the Rangers. Linden with two for Vancouver. Messier, Graves, and Anderson with Lidster and Leach. And Obukaboom is returned to the bench. He's not returned to the ice. Leach shoots through a crowd. It was tipped wide. McClain never saw it. Never moved. Lifted clear by Adams. Anderson, though, kept it in on the line. McClain leaves it for Gerald Dittick. Off the boards for Adams.
Rangers need that forechecking game again to keep Vancouver off balance, to keep Vancouver's defense from joining the rush, and maybe draw another penalty.
Messier moving in. Bumps with Dittick. The puck is loose. So is a glove. Babich has it. Moves it ahead for Adams. Up the middle of Craven. Leach is back. 2-on-1. Leach intercepts. As Zelenov is cutting in. Graves the other way. He's bumped along the boards by Adams. Puck taken back by Babich. Gets it to Craven. Craven shoots. Deflected wide. Went off the skate. Zelenov just missed the rebound. Anderson moves it out to Graves. Graves dumps in. 13:25 to go in the third. Rangers leading 3-2. But the Canucks are putting the pressure on. Lining the Brown. Vanesso is bumped by Lowe. Zuboff has the puck. Ronning on him. Off the boards, Hedekin. Ronning's got it. Laid it across. Mateau takes over and sends it in. In the corner, Larmer and Hedekin. Larmer got knocked down by Brett Hedekin. Ronning couldn't play it. Larmer gets up. Trying to work it loose. But a whistle stops play. 12:53 to go in the third.
Stefan Mateau has really had a great game. It's the best he's skated in a while. I don't know how he skates or what he skates on. He's got a pair of skates that are a couple of years old, and if you look at the toes, the training staff led by Mike Volga, he has done everything to try it. Look at the black stuff on the bottom underneath the toes of his feet there. He has tried to work these blades to get one more game out of them, and this will be the last game that those skates will ever see, believe me. He has been good. He's been aggressive. He skated well. He's read plays. And this is tight. Oh.
Fans rising to their feet at the Garden in a Let's Go Rangers chant. Rangers have done well on the faceoffs. McTavish on with Kekkonen and Noonan, Zuboff and Wells. Linden with Cortnall and Lafayette. Lume and Glenn. Linden wins it in the corner. Yerke Lume plays the puck. Lume off the boards. Wells sends it back. McTavish trying to gain control. Knocked away from him. Cortnall lifts it to Lafayette. Back for Linden. Linden moving in is checked by Noonan. Noonan got it, rather Linden got the shot off, and Richter stops it.
And looked like Richter's stick may have been off the ice a little bit, and he just caught the top portion of the puck. Trevor Linden uses his body so well to shield the opposition player to find a way to get the shot. Let's watch as the Rangers turn the puck over in the neutral zone. Watch. See the lean there by Linden? Now he gets the shot. Look at Richter's stick. He got the save. That's what he needed. Linden with a good job keeping his balance. Again, see the shot go through. Richter hangs on. Another defensive drive.
Linden really playing a strong game seven for Vancouver.
He uses his body so well, again, to shield the opposition.
Messier, a good win on the faceoff. Lidstrom able to move it to Anderson. He gets clear. Messier picks it up and moves across. Messier to Graves. Graves shoots wide. Around the boards, Lidstrom is there. He winds up, his shot blocked in front. Cleared by Lume to Linden. Linden moving in on Brian Leetch. Leetch takes him out with the hip check. Lidstrom gets to the puck, is bumped by Lafayette. And Linden moves in with a hit. Lidstrom still has the puck and comes away with it. Off the boards and out of the zone. Just under 12 minutes to go. As the Rangers take an icing, 11:53 on the clock. Brian Leetch with the big hit. Along the boards, taking out Trevor Linden on the rush.
Leetch will love to use the hip check if he has the player to the outside. And that's a good play to take the man out. You have to make sure you take the body, because if you miss, you take yourself out of the play. The stamina, so important now for Brian Leetch, as he's played a lot. Glenn Healy, who's got the best seat in the house, really acting as a great cheerleader for his teammates.
Al Trotwig is at ice side. What do you see, Al?
Well, Sam, what I see is a very, very tired Doug Lidstrom. You know, Puka Boom's not out there. And like the third period of Game 5, the Rangers defensemen are getting an awful lot of pressure. It's been showing, at least to me, on his face in a big way.
McTavish wins the faceoff from Ronning. The puck rolls out of the zone. Around the boards, past Richter. Zuboff is there. It trickles out of the zone. It's picked up by McTavish. Ahead for Noonan. Noonan on Dittick. McTavish to the net. Noonan trying to get by Dittick. He blocked it. McTavish slides it out of the zone. Zuboff moves it back. Ronning trying to hit Bure. Lowe's got the puck. It's Bure with Promesso and Ronning now. Kekkonen takes the long pass and dumps it ahead. Got hit by Dittick.
Bure getting double shifted in place of Zelina. Bure, the better scorer.
Leetch sends it back to the Vancouver zone. Picked up by Babich. Rangers leading 3-2. As Babich fires ahead, Larmer knocks it away from Craven. Brought in by Kovalov with 11 minutes to go. Kovalov toward the net. And sliding into the net with Steve Larmer. Kovalov upset as he was hit in the corner by Dittick.
Last couple of shifts. Vancouver's tried to break the game, and the Rangers have fought back. Larmer goes to the net. You can see he's just simply hauled down by Pavel Bure. No penalty. Again, good play by McLean to avoid Steve Larmer. Kovalov tried to put the puck in front. It was blocked. As the whistle sounds, he got thumped. He got thumped in the corner by Gerald Dittick, who's played a tough game.
10:56 to go. Brian Leetch, 27 shifts, almost 27 minutes of ice time. Brett Hennigan sends it ahead. Greg Adams moves in, and Lidstrom steps up with a fine defensive play. Zelina after the puck. Lidstrom's tackle and a whistle. Stops play as Lidstrom's on top of the puck. Greg Adams hauled him down. 10:43 to go. Third period. Rangers leading 3-2.
Finally made it to the big leagues. In my first game, we get the call. And I'm thinking, how lucky can a guy get?
Each to it aged for that fresh, distinctive taste. Crisp, clean, classic.
We both had to get home for Mom's birthday. Charlie took his car. I took the train. He had detours. I had Danish. He took a break. I took a nap. He had company. I had companions. Oh, we both ended up in the same place, but not in the same shape.
Something about a train that's magic. Oh, Amtrak.
Commissioner Gary Bettman, his wife Shelley in attendance, looking on. It's been a great playoff for the National Hockey League.
I think the commissioner, Mr. Bettman, will be very proud of the way the playoffs have moved along, and especially the way these two teams have conducted themselves. This has been a spectacle. Brilliant hockey.
3-2 Rangers, 10:43 to go in the third. Craven and Messier for the faceoff. Craven with Adams and Jelena as Pat Quinn is shaking up the lines a little bit. Change things up.
Well, to take Bore away from Craven is quite interesting.
Put Ronning with it.
Well, Ronning, he must say, has been a better playmaker than any of his other centermen in this game.
Oh, a tough bouncer that Richter went down. It was an offside.
It was an offside, but I'll tell you what. The infield didn't look too good on that play, did it? Messier's 12-6 on faceoffs. Watch this thing. The puck skips. The flex skips. Richter played it well. It was a difficult play. A little deflection right there off Kevin Lowe, and the puck is fluttering and bouncing.
Wow.
Time isn't moving very quickly, is it right now?
Not for Ranger fans. 10:25 to go as Kovalov wins the faceoff. Zuboff has the puck. Now Kevin Lowe lifts it toward the Vancouver zone. Hedekin stops the puck. Right back out. Lowe chases back. Now Jeff Brown. Controlled by Craven. He sends into the Ranger zone. Midway point of the third period. Rangers leading 3-2. Adams moves it. Craven wrapped up by Lowe. Zuboff trying to get away. Fired out. Here's Kovalov with Brown back. Kovalov holds up. Look, speed alarmer. Save McClain. Matteau is hit. Matteau keeps the puck alive in the corner. Kovalov moves in. Hedekin checking in. Matteau tries to work it loose. Kovalov's got it along the board. Took a hard hit by Craven. Puck behind the net. Jeff Brown moves out with it. 9.5 minutes to go. And once again, Vancouver had too many men on the ice in a sloppy change.
They're not going to call it, Sam, in this situation.
And they call against Boston and Don Cherry. Here's a puck knocked away. Here's McTavish to Noonan. Noonan to Leach. Across to Lidstrom for the shot blocked by Lafayette. Peeking it along the boards, but a whistle stops play.
Not
Gary
exactly
Gregson
sure.
Talking with Craig McTavish here.
Gregson, he
penalties
seems to be calling penalties,
up.
Maybe one to each player.
Yeah. McTavish and Linden.
Rangers, I think, would love to take that trade-off. Linden has 2 goals in the game, and maybe has been the best forward for Vancouver. Craig McTavish has played well, but the Rangers have the lead.
A real winner knows how to party right. Please, use good sense when you drink. Know when to say when. A reminder from Budweiser. 9:05 to go in the third. Rangers leading 3-2. And let's see.
There's Vancouver. Counting the goaltender, you see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 players, and you'll see someone come off the bench. Again, 5 skaters. And there's the extra, and it did hit the foot. Look at the hands of the linesman in the background waving. No, nothing.
That was Kevin Collins.
I don't think you'll see anything cheap like that called in this situation. At least I hope not.
They'll skate 4 aside for 2 minutes. Linden and McTavish, 2 minutes each for roughing at 10:55. And as you mentioned, John, Pat Quinn upset with the call because he loses Trevor Linden, who probably has been his best player tonight.
I think that's without a doubt. Rangers seem to be delaying their changes here, Sam, and I think the reason is they're trying to rest their defense. Each change, Vancouver's had their players waiting for the faceoff, and the Rangers have been very deliberate. And there's no doubt that without Bookaboom, some of the players are getting a lot more ice time, and they need the break.
Lowe takes the shot. Hit the post! Lidster swings it around. That could have been the one. Kevin Lowe came oh so close. Lafayette played it ahead. Lidster back for it. Lowe and Lidster with Messier and Braves on a 4-on-4. Messier had to go off his stick. Lume with Glynn, Courtnall, and Craven. Lowe all over Courtnall. Forces the turnover. Graves has the puck. Now Messier. 8:35 to go in the third. Rangers leading 3-2. Vancouver a goal here in the third. Cut into the Rangers' two-goal lead. Messier and Graves. Messier to Graves. He shoots and it's blocked by Babbitt. Courtnall has the puck. Met by Messier who knocked it away. Once again, Vancouver changes.
Their changes have been awful.
Oh, yeah.
They might get caught the way they're changing.
Leach. Nice pass to Tikkanen. He moves in on Hedekin. Lost control. Swings by Hedekin. In deep is Larmer. Larmer gets to the puck. Wraps it around right through the crease. Just under 8 minutes to go. A glove goes flying in the air. It's Tikkanen's glove. Hedekin has the puck. He's forced back by Larmer. Larmer was tripped up. Hedekin out for Bure. Bure gets by Leach. Moves in on Zubov. Hook checked away by Zubov. Good play by Sergei Zubov. Pressure from Bure. Tikkanen trying to control. He's hit by Bure. Tikkanen moving with a puck. Tikkanen comes out of the zone, feeds Leach. Leach moving in on Jeff Brown. He shoots, save McClain. 15 seconds left in a 4-on-4. Brown moves out with a puck for Vancouver. 3-2 Rangers leading it. Brown shoots, saved by Richter. Tough low shot by Jeff Brown. Noonan playing it across and Gatto gets to it. Gatto picked up by Ronning. Keeps back at full strength on the ice. 7 minutes to go in the third. Up the boards, it's blocked by Gatto. Gatto looking to make a pass. Gatto around the net. He's looking. He sees Noonan. Save made by McClain. Out comes Jelena. Lowe is back. Jelena with Linden and Ronning. Pass to Ronning. Now to Jelena. Hit the post. And it's cleared by Lowe. Oh, man. Vancouver came oh so close to tying it.
Both teams close to scoring. Kirk McClain with a big save. As Brian Noonan had the shot on the Mantle setup. And then Vancouver on the rush just hit the outside of the goalpost. Mike Richter even lost his glove on the play. Kirk McClain quietly stands there. Look how quietly he stands on this play. Noonan releases to the right side. Shot. The puck didn't get through. Now look at this. It's a 3-on-2. Ronning gives the puck back. The shot. Oh, was that close? And then was it close again? As Lowe fired the puck away. Kevin Lowe hit the goalpost. This was earlier. It's still 3-2. There's 6:36 to go.
Now, John, you saw Richter reach out and his glove went off.
Did he throw his glove?
Did he?
I don't know.
And if it had hit the puck, what would that have been?
Oh, maybe a penalty shot. It doesn't matter now.
No, 6:36 to go as Messier faces off with Linden and wins. And Lowe plays to Zubov. His pass blocked, but he chips it out. Back for the puck comes Gerald Dinnick. 3-2 Rangers with 6:25 to go in the third. Messier in after the puck. Messier hit from behind by Dinnick. Back into the Vancouver zone it goes. Babich has the puck. Up the boards with Jeff Courtnall. Now to Trevor Linden. Back to Courtnall. Zubov is there. The shot saved Richter. Courtnall centers. Saved by Richter! Lafayette had a chance. I thought he got the glove on it. It might have hit the post.
If he stopped it, it's a save of anybody's career.
Back in. Moe's got the puck. 5:45 to go. Vancouver pressing for the tie. The Rangers sending it down. Intercepted by Kovalov. Can't get a shot off as he's knocked down by Hedekin. The puck taken by Larmer. Larmer shoots high. Off the glass around the Lidster. Lidster sending it to Gatto. Gatto waiting. Toward the net. Larmer's knocked down in the crease. Where's the puck? Kovalov's got it. Puts it in the crease and block. Out comes Bure. And a whistle behind the play. The net is knocked off. What a wild sequence. 5:18 to go in the third. Gregson says the faceoff is outside. We'll step out for a moment.
Is that Johnson's team behind us?
Exactly.
Are they members of Hertz Number One Club Gold?
Exactly.
Are we members of Hertz Number
One? Not exactly.
So thanks to Hertz, they're going to get to the meeting on time.
And we'll be late. So exactly what'll I tell the boss?
In Rent-A-Car, there's Hertz, and there's not exactly. Make sure you choose the right one.
And then a dog in the cargo hold ate our presentation.
Is he buying it?
Not exactly.
A startling proposal heads for New Orleans. A hard-fought contract is Chicago-bound. Three sets of contact lenses are expected in Tampa by tomorrow morning. Express mail from the Postal Service will get them there, overnight, guaranteed, from just $9.95. Every day, morning. Overnight, we deliver for you.
It was a fabulous try by Mike Richter, but he got help from the post.
Each team has had a goal post in this third period. Lafayette, he beat Richter, but he didn't put the puck on the inside of the goal post and hit the outside and stayed out. Oh, is that close? Very close. And you can see then Lafayette was cleared out of the goal crease.
Actually, Vancouver's hit the post twice. Yelena hit the post earlier.
Yeah, I thought that was the outside of the post, but it was still close. Vancouver's resilient, and they're showing it. The Rangers love the timeouts, and they love each stoppage. They're trying to take as much time as possible to rest their defensemen.
Lonning with Bourret and Momesso for Vancouver. Brown and Hedekin. Rangers have McTavish, Noonan, and Tikkanen with Leach and Lidstrom. Rangers without Jeff Bukabum, who suffered a leg injury. No icing. Lidstrom going back. Momesso hooking him. Lidstrom tries to move away. Got tripped up by Momesso. And it's intercepted by Lidstrom coming back on the pass by Ronning. McTavish moving in. McTavish on Hennigan. McTavish looking. Around the boards to Noonan. Noonan holding along the boards. Centers for Zuboff off his stick. Momesso checked by Tikkanen, who wrestles him down, and Noonan sends it in. 4:25 to go. Red Hedekin out to Yerke Lume. Graves knocks it down. Taken back by Vancouver's Brian Glenn. Across the line, Craven. To the puck, Jelena overskated. Anderson trying to clear. Lowe trying to clear. They get it out of the zone. Taken back by Lume. Into the corner. Leach goes for the puck. Leach takes a hit but moves the puck. Rangers clear the zone.
Vancouver with a lot of very slow, deliberate dump-ins. And then they're punishing, trying to create turnovers. And the Rangers are called for icing. This will be another slow change, I would think, by the Rangers. As Mike Keenan looks on, I don't think he was happy with the icing call. However, it is. And it's a defensive draw. Vancouver, when they've shot the puck in, they're shooting it softly into the corners. And they're just trying to punish and regain control of the puck.
3:52 remaining in the third period. Rangers leading 3-2.
Here the Rangers with a slow change again. Taking every opportunity to buy time. Buy time. McTavish will be out for the draw. I guess Murray Craven is good on the draw. Mike Keenan bunts. Neil Smith and Larry Blow. They feel it.
Craven with Jelena and Adams. McTavish with Tikkanen and Noonan. Slides to the boards. Leach goes for the puck and lifts it out. And back for it comes Gerald Dittick. Forechecking is Noonan. Up the boards. Tikkanen couldn't play it. Jelena sends it ahead. He's upended by Tikkanen. Leach to Zuboff. Zuboff pulls back. Plays it off the boards and out of the zone. Dittick sends it in. 3:25 to go. Leach, double team, and he is hit along the boards, but he moved the puck to Tikkanen. Now to Sergei Zuboff. Zuboff across. Stick handles in. McLean clears it aside. Kevin Lowe comes on and drives it back into the Vancouver zone. 3:10 to go. Gerald Dittick looks up. Matto forechecking. Marmer is on. Kovalov's on. Off the board. Blocked by Kovalov. Matto is checked along the boards by Babich. Kovalov reaching for the puck.
Canucks bring it out. Jeff Courtnall sends it in. Lowe got a piece of it with the glove. Lidstrom plays it. 2:48 to go. Off the boards for Komolov to Matteau. Here's Komolov to two-line pass.
Faceoff will go back inside the Rangers zone once again. 2:44 to go. Pavel Bure should be well rested. Mike Richter gets another water bottle. He tries to put fluid back in his system. The teams have their timeouts remaining. Ranger fans are standing. Vancouver fans are hoping. And we have 2:44 to go in the third period.
They're on their feet, fans of all ages.
They might be on their feet in their homes and their apartments and wherever they're watching.
Ernie Grunfeld of the Knicks in attendance. Ranger fans alive as the Rangers lead 3-2.
The big boys, Bure, Linden, Courtnell, Brown, Hennigan. It's all offense right now for Vancouver.
And it's Messier, Graves, Anderson, Leach, and Lidstrom for the Rangers. As the Rangers set the defense, Leach is working at Bure.
Faceoffs are a five-man responsibility.
Richter steers the Lidster. Moves it up the boards for Graves. Out of the zone, Messier after it. Courtnall gets there. Gets it back to Linden. 2.5 minutes to go. Hennigan moves in. Hennigan toward the net, wide. Around the boards, Messier takes a hard hit from Linden. Graves gets to the puck. He's pressured. He lifts it. Clear out of the zone. Brown back for the puck. Anderson after him. 2:15 to go. The puck past Leach. Courtnall chops at Leach. Zubov. Cleared out by Zubov. Taken back by Ronning. Ronning moves across. Zubov is there. Courtnall's pass was blocked. Turgenet blocked by Leach. Moves it to the boards. Graves chips it out of the zone. Sent back in. No, it was kept in by Lume. Fans didn't like it. Leach pressured by Bure. Gave it up to Ronning. Loose puck. Ronning chips it back to Lume. Lume moving down the boards. Rangers can't gain control. Bure behind the net. Bure taken down by Zubov. And Zubov lifts it clear. And right now you can get away with anything. And that's why Zubov tripped up Bure. Might as well do it.
Brian Noonan didn't have a stick. The Rangers had chances to get the puck over the blue line and couldn't. So now you'll see timeouts used as the best players, the majority have been on the ice. Jeff Courtnell's at the Vancouver bench. He can hardly get over the boards. He's so tired. Brian Leach and Zubov have to be exhausted, but it's the hearts that are big. Oh, you see here, Ronning had the glorious chance, but the Rangers surrounded him. The puck is along the boards. Noonan's in front without a stick. Zubov trips his man up, and then he just ices the puck.
Canucks have called timeout as you watch the puck sent down the ice for icing. 1:31 to go, third period. Rangers 3, Canucks 2. Pat Quinn talking to his team. Don't forget, the Canucks came back in game one and tied that game with exactly 1 minute to go and won in overtime. The Rangers have given up leads late in the playoffs to New Jersey and Vancouver. It's a very tense time. Al is downstairs. Al, what's going on?
Well, Sam, I'm right by the glass. Behind me is pandemonium, but a very special moment. Neil Smith came down from his perch, made his way with police escort to watch the last 1:31 with his wife, Katya. Meanwhile, the table to hold the Stanley Cup is behind me. The New York City police are moving into position, and Madison Square Garden is ready to count it down. It's wild down here.
Kirk McLean is still in goal. Thanks, Al. Kirk McLean is still in goal. There's 1:31 to go.
Okay. Will this crowd get a chance to celebrate? Defense is the chant. 1:31 on the clock.
Terry Gregson trying to stop the Canucks from making a late change. Pavel Bure is on the bench, but he could be the player to come on if the goaltender goes to the bench.
Lume and Babich, Craven, Jelena, and Adams for Vancouver. McTavish with Noonan and Kekkonen, Leach and Lidstrom for the Rangers. Ray Scapinello set to drop the puck between Craven and McTavish. Craven wins. Lume moves in with a puck. Lume to the net, knocked away by a sliding Leach. Noonan tied up by Adams. Lindster is hit by Jelena. The puck in the corner comes loose, but Gregson blew the whistle, stopping play.
Murray Craven has taken every big offensive zone drive for the Canucks, and he won the last one clean. And did Brian Leach ever read the play? Oh, my. You'll see here, Lume move in. Now watch Brian Leach in front of Richter. Bang. He leads with a stick and knocks the puck aside. Now the Rangers have rested the Messier line, and he'll come on for the faceoff.
1:20 to go.
Vancouver going with their bigger players, Sam. If they can get to the front of the net, they'll create a big screen. Bigger players. There's no Ronning and Bure on the ice.
Messier with Raids and Larmer as Kekkonen goes off. Craven for the faceoff. McLean still in the net. Craven wins. Tapped back to Lume. Toward the net. Knocked down by Messier. He moves it for Larmer. Larmer is stopped. Messier swings it around. Leach goes for it with 1:10 to go. Lifts it out of the zone with 1:05 to go. Adams back to Lume. Lume has the puck with 1 minute to go in the third period. McLean heads to the bench. Extra man on for Vancouver. The puck cleared out. 55 seconds to go.
Vancouver's made a bad change. They haven't got the players.
And seven men on the ice. 45 seconds to go. Lume's got the puck. Shoots it in. Richter stops it. Zuboff plays it. Up into the crowd. 30. The clock still ticking off.
That'll
a couple
checked.
Of seconds.
They'll be checking it upstairs. They have a timekeeper with a stopwatch. In the replay booth, the officials will be checking it. When the puck went in the stands, Momesso looked up immediately. I think you'll see 1 or 2 seconds put back on the clock. And Vancouver, when the goaltender went to the bench, had a horrific line change or player change, and they were all messed up. Pucks in the stands, and the clock kept ticking.
Well, the puck went up in the crowd, and again, Pat Quinn wants time put on the clock. To this point, it has not been put back on. It's 36.2 on the clock. Have to say this, at one point, there may have been 7 or 8 Canucks on the ice.
Well, they just, nobody knew who to jump on the ice. Nobody knew who to go off the ice, and they lost 2 or 3 valuable seconds.
And now Terry Gregson has been called over to the official scorer's table. And I believe they are looking at the tape upstairs for time.
Oh, sure. They have people in place for this. They'll look at it. They'll make sure. And I believe at least 1 second will be put back on the clock. I may be wrong, but it certainly appeared as though the clock kept clicking, ticking away.
36. I think it may be close to 2 seconds, John. It ticked off.
Vancouver has the goaltender head to the bench. Look at over on the right side. Look at the players. They don't know who's coming on, who's going off.
There's 7 on there right now. 7 Canucks.
Nonetheless, faceoff is to the left side, the near side of Mike Richter. Murray Craven has won the last 2 faceoffs in the Rangers zone, but they were on the other side of the ice. 1.6 seconds have been added onto the clock.
37.8 remaining. Rangers leading 3-2.
Vancouver's already used their timeout. But here they're extending it a little bit. Pat Quinn's telling everybody to move up ice. Messier, 15-7 on draws in the game. That doesn't matter much now.
Rangers 3, Canucks 2. 37.8 seconds remaining. Kirk McLean taking a peek, hoping his team can find a way to score a goal to keep it tied, to tie the game. The Rangers trying to hold on to win the Stanley Cup for the first time in 54 years. And a false start on the faceoff. Linden and Messier.
That was Linden, pardon me, Momesso who jumped in, so Linden should be out of there.
Along the board. Zuboff fires it around the glass. It's out of the zone. Back for the puck goes Jeff Brown. 30 seconds to go.
Oh, that's a bad
call. Oh, they called it icing. The Rangers can't believe it.
That is a bad call in my estimation. That should have been waved off. Kevin Collins called it icing. But Jeff Brown, credit Jeff Brown. He slowed his skating down to make sure the puck went over the red line. The Rangers have to retain their composure. You'll see the puck get fired around and down the ice. Now watch the defenseman right in the view now. Watch him slow. Look at him. He stopped skating. Now the puck's over the red line. That should not have been icing. Look at him slow down.
28.2 seconds remaining. Once again, Messier and Craven.
Now this is the side where Craven won his last two faceoffs on that side of the ice.
Craven with Courtnall, Lomesso, Linden, Bure, and Brown. And Craven delaying with the stick. Adjusting the glove. Now Craven steps in. Craven against Messier. Messier gets to the puck. Moves it. It's blocked by Courtnall. In deep. Bounces past Linden. Leach trying to play it. Lomesso centers and was stopped by Zuboff. Linden back pass. Bure shoots. Blocked in front. Into the corner it goes. Courtnall hits Zuboff for the pass. Zuboff swings it around. Weimer clears the zone. That's it. 54 years of curses are over. No more 1940.
Yes.
The New York Rangers are going to win.
It's 1.1 seconds on the clock, and Kevin Collins, I can't believe he allowed this to be icing again. Sam, there's 1.1 seconds on the clock.
1.1.
I'd like to see
hold the celebration
again.
One more time.
Got to see the replay again. I mean, Pavel Bure stopped skating.
54 years of curses and jinxes. 54 years of heartache. The chant of "We want the cup."
I concur with Mike Keenan. And Neil Smith hasn't won it yet. It's 1.1 seconds to go. Now Bure will go after the puck. Watch him stop skating. He stops.
No.
That should not be icing. I'm sorry. But it is. There's 1.1 seconds to go.
Mike Keenan on the top step. He is on the ledge. Every person in Madison Square Garden on their feet.
Murray Craven's a left-handed shot. He'll, I think, try to go to the net when the puck is dropped.
This is the moment they have waited for a lifetime.
There's a lot of toilet paper on the ice. They're waiting to have that all cleared up before the puck will be dropped. That allows both teams to set their strategy.
3-2 Rangers. They have put back 0.5 seconds, 1.6 on the clock. Now, John, if I'm the Rangers, I just dive on top of the puck.
Absolutely. Now, it looks like it may be Bure taking the faceoff. And he'll just try to drive it towards the goal, I would think.
1.6 seconds.
They have one man back, and that's Brown. Bure's going to go ahead with quick hands. McTavish will have to nullify it.
Here it is. The waiting is over. The New York Rangers are the Stanley Cup champions. And this one will last a lifetime.
No more curses. This is unbelievable. These people have waited a long time. Fans, players, coaches. Unbelievable.
Let the celebration begin.
What a series. Two fabulous teams. Vancouver lost, but hockey was the winner. For the New York Rangers and their supporters, no more 1940. It's gone. Congratulations, Rangers.
The 1994 New York Rangers have done it. And for every Ranger that ever put on a uniform, they can stand with pride. What a moment. A moment that has never been known at Madison Square Garden.
And on behalf of the former Rangers, thank you, 1994 Rangers. This is something special. Oh, remember this. Enjoy it.
Messier, Keenan, Leach, Kovalov, the first Russians to win a Stanley Cup.
Mark Messier delivered, folks. Mike Richter delivered.
Yes, he did. Joey Koser couldn't play tonight. He joins in the celebration. This is worth waiting for. Mike Keenan. His first year as coach of the New York Rangers, and he delivered. And what a sad finish for a proud team. The Vancouver Canucks showing guts, coming back from 3-1 down in the series and battling back in this game from a two-goal deficit twice.
The Rangers worked all season long. First game was September 11th in England, in London, England. They worked all season long to get home ice. And they had home ice for the seventh game. They had their fans. They had the extra day off. They lost Jeff Bookaboom, who gave it everything but couldn't come back. And they won it. This is really something special. Two great hockey teams, a wonderful sport, a great handshake. It just doesn't get any better.
It took 107 games. And the New York Rangers have become the Stanley Cup champions. And the chant of 1940 has gone up from the crowd.
I'd love to hear it one more time.
Last time. You will not hear this again. No more 1940. Pavel Bure, what a proud, proud player. What a great one. And there he is. The Messiah has delivered.
Celebrate, party, enjoy. This has been an incredible roller coaster ride that ended up on the very top of the roller coaster.
And now the presentation of the Conn Smythe Trophy to the MVP of the playoffs, and then the moment they've waited a lifetime for, the Stanley Cup.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand by for the official presentation of the Conn Smythe Trophy and the Stanley Cup. Ladies and gentlemen, to present the Conn Smythe Trophy to the 1994 Stanley Cup Playoffs Most Valuable Player, Commissioner Gary Bettman.
The winner of the Smythe Trophy as the most valuable player in the Stanley Cup playoffs is Brian Leetch.
The first American-born player to ever win the Conn Smythe Trophy, the sixth defenseman to ever be so honored.
He won the Rookie of the Year. He won the Norris Trophy as the most valuable defenseman, and now he's won the biggest of them all. The Conn Smythe winner,
Conn Smythe winner, Brian Leetch of the New York Rangers.
Just wait. You're going to see the most beautiful piece of silver, the most wonderful. The Holy Grail is coming out, folks. This is just an incredible piece. Bob Gutkowski, the president of the Madison Square Garden, Neil Smith, Mike Keenan. Oh, does that mean something? These people have worked so hard.
Ladies and gentlemen,
hang on.
The Stanley Cup.
Whether you're a fan 4 years old, 64 years old, 84 years old, no matter how long you've waited, this is something special.
Look at the hands. These guys have white gloves on carrying the Stanley Cup. That is precious. It's beautiful. And it's going to have the New York Rangers all over it.
Well, New York, after 54 years, your long wait is over. congratulations to the Rangers and the Vancouver Canucks for a spectacular finals. Congratulations to Bob Gutkowski, Neil Smith, and Mike Keenan, the entire Ranger organization, and most importantly, the players. Captain Mark Messier, come get the Stanley Cup.
Tina Turner's song, simply the best, blaring on the loudspeaker. That's the song the Rangers listened to before the game.
He came to New York 3 years ago to deliver the Stanley Cup, and there it is.
Looking up at his family right now, saying, I can't believe it.
How sweet it is. Kevin Lowe, a great champion. And there's the great one, Brian Leetch.
Brian Leetch had his shoulder frozen 3 or 4 times in the New Jersey Devils series just so he could play.
Adam Graves, the second time he has held the cup. Jay Wells, 15 years. Oh, look at that. 15 years he's waited for that. Esa Tikkanen. Another great veteran, Steve Larmer. Greg Gilbert. One of the veterans brought in, and now the Black Aces, Eddie Olczyk.
This team stayed together all season long. Look at Sergei Nemchinov. They know what it means. Alexei Kovalov, you should be proud of yourself the way you played in this game. A spectacular game.
There's the man. Yes. Mike Richter, boy, did he deliver in the clutch.
They love their goalies in New York City, and Mike Richter is at the top.
Ryan Noonan, Stephen Matteau, two players who came over to help solidify this team. Sergei Zubov, did he ever develop into a great one this year?
Joey Koser couldn't play due to injury. Jeff Bookaboom, and you hear the boo for Bookaboom. This team believed. Oh, did they believe? And oh, was it tough. That is such a tough, tough trophy to win. You do anything to win. And did Dougie Lidster have a game when
yes.
he had to play?
Mike Hudson. What a special moment for these players. In my mind, this is the hardest championship to win. And now the chance that will live a lifetime, 1994. Glenn Anderson once again. He may not be in the NHL next season. He wanted to go out with a Stanley Cup. Alexander Karpovtsev takes in on the festivities.
Oh, and I just saw how he rolls.
Mike Keenan.
That looks like a New York Ranger coach to me.
Well, he says he'd like to win it again. Yes, there's the headline. It is.
Millions of fans in New York City who just, they're all a part of this. The support over the years. Everybody's a part of it. Neil Smith, congratulations.
5 years of hard work in putting this team together. And finally it's arrived. Colin Campbell. Dick Todd in his first year in the NHL. It's 36 inches long. It weighs 36 pounds.
It's time for a team photo. SCA did this a lot with the Edmonton Oilers. Get the teammates over. It's impromptu. You put that beautiful piece of silver there. Hey, all right.
Marv Albert has waited 28 years for this.
And how about our buddy Sal Messina? He's been a fan since the 50s.
Man, he was a Ranger player. Sat
right
up in the stands as a backup goalie. How much does it mean to him?
This is the greatest photo for a team sport that these players will ever have. Look at the faces. Here comes Mike. Just look at the faces. His scars, his cuts, his teeth missing. Every bit of it was worth it.
A long journey. The marathon. And the Rangers win it.
Tinkin and who else?
How does it feel for you as a former Ranger?
Special, Sam. This is the chant the Rangers have had every day of practice all season long. Heave ho, pull together. Heave ho, pull together. That's what you need when you win championships in hockey, is a team pointed in the same direction that pulls together. And baby, these guys did it. This was so special, so wonderful. This team, Sam, the bond that they now have for the rest of their lives is incredible. And Messier, well, he just doesn't want to leave.
A moment to cherish. Kowski with Sergei Nemchinov, the man who led the Russians here to the Rangers and is a proud player. And now, Al Trotwig is down on the ice with Mike Keenan. Al.
Sam, I don't know if this is really happening or not, but I'm going to go with it for now. Mike, what is it about this trophy? What is it about this Stanley Cup that can make a man, a tough man like you, come to tears when he wins it?
It's just so bloody hard to achieve. And fortunate, I've had four cracks. It was my 10th year, and it took me 10 years to get my name on it. I feel fortunate because a lot of guys played in this league, and a lot of guys have coached this league and been managers and never get their name on it. I had a hell of a hockey club, and they came through.
Mike, I know you've said many times that the weight of 54 years could be turned into a positive, but can you describe for me in reality, now that you've won it, what the weight of this franchise's past history has been like?
It really wasn't a weight because these players handled it so well. We used it as positive energy, and I said that earlier in the year, and I still believe it.
What was it like to sit there surrounded by your team and sit next to that Stanley Cup? And before that, hold it up to this crowd. What did it feel like?
Well, the crowd, I don't think they're just beginning to understand how to act right now, and that's great. They deserve it, too. They put a lot of time and effort into this as well, and the greatest thing is to sit there with your team and know that they were committed from day one and they pulled it off. They were the lead horse going into it, and that's where they ended up. I'm very, very proud of them.
Mike, you are, after all, the head coach. What's the coaching move that you're most proud of that brought this cup to New York?
The coaching move, I think, was being hired by Neil Smith and having an opportunity to coach this group.
How about convincing this team about commitment? How did you pull that off?
It wasn't hard. The leadership was here before I got here, basically, in terms of the core group, and we just added to it, and they've been committed from day one, as I said.
Mark
Messier is the greatest leader in the game, and he showed us that he was the one that had to pull it off here.
There's no curfew tonight for the players, is there?
No, we're going to have a day off tomorrow.
Thank you a lot, Coach. All right, Mike Keenan, Sam, we'll talk to a lot more of the Stanley Cup winning Rangers. Let's go back to you for now.
They are celebrating on the streets of New York, outside Madison Square Garden. The party begins inside, spreads outside. What a wonderful, wonderful moment. As for the first time ever, the New York Rangers can carry the Stanley Cup at Madison Square Garden. Yes, it is. And what a great, great playoff. It started with the sweep of the Islanders, five-game win over the Washington Capitals, and then the marvelous series with the New Jersey Devils that went to double overtime in Game 7. And what could match that except a Stanley Cup final that went to the seventh game, a one-goal victory for the Rangers, 3-2.
We'll make a little room for another one of those banners that's been a long time coming to support. Fabulous. Absolutely fabulous. Detroit, last won the Stanley Cup in 1955. And you know what? That's now the longest drought. Isn't that sweet music?
The man who delivered, the captain, is with Al Trotwig right now. Al?
Well, Sam, for the first time in the illustrious career of Mark Messier, he has scored the goal that has won the Stanley Cup. And I don't know if you care about things like that, but it's just one little extra thing.
No, it doesn't matter anyways. When one person scores, we all score. I'm so numb right now, I don't know what to say. There's so many things to talk about to tell everybody, but right now I can't think of anything, but just so happy to win it.
Well, Mark, always the most recent achievement seems to be the most enjoyable, but when you consider that you came here with an almost impossible mission in the minds of many Ranger fans to deliver this cup after the previous success in Edmonton, how can you compare this?
Well, I think it's the Stanley Cup's obvious in Edmonton were special. It'll be a big place in my heart forever. This is completely different. The pressure, the magnitude of the city playing under the microscope that we did, the challenge of winning a cup here for 54 years, erasing all the ghosts everybody talked to is incredible. And I just want to say one thing. Yesterday, Mike Keenan addressed the team for about 15 minutes in the dressing room. It was the most powerful, the most intense, the most emotional speech I've ever heard in my entire life. He seized the moment, he took control of the situation, he got the team back on control. And I'm telling you, you can say whatever you want about Mike Keenan, but yesterday he came through when we needed him, and he's a big reason for a win today.
Mark, take a look behind you, the joy, the celebration. This has been an unbelievable bumpy ride. It's been a great ride. There have been some big bumps in it. What's the key moment of this whole achievement, the commitment that sticks out in your mind?
Just from the first trophy we won in September, the French Maid's Trophy, when we went over to England. And we never looked back. Mike kept his foot on the throttle the whole year. He pushed us. And nothing for free. There's going to be trouble. There's going to be arguments. There's going to be things. But that's why it's so sweet when you do overcome all the hurdles and win it. And let me tell you, Mike Keenan deserves a lot of credit.
All right. Enjoy the champagne.
As well as this guy right here.
Oh, look who I have here, the Conn Smythe winner himself. Brian, congratulations.
Thanks, Al. It's unbelievable. It was the toughest game I've ever been a part of having to win. That fourth game, I don't know what to say. It was just so tough to win.
Brian, you're such a modest man. When it came time to go over and get that Conn Smythe, it seemed as though you were a little hesitant. You wanted somebody to go with you. You looked at Messier. Tell me about that moment.
I just told Mess I wanted the whole team up there for pictures because we couldn't have done it without everyone. It was an unbelievable team effort. We pulled together every time we needed to. Mike Richter was the best goal I've ever seen. Some of the saves he made. It's unbelievable. It's amazing.
What does it mean to you to be the first American to have his name inscribed on that all-important trophy?
Well, I haven't even thought of that. It's just like the Stanley Cup is what we all play for, and down the road it'll be great to look back on, but that cup here in New York, it's amazing.
It's right over our heads, as a matter of fact. It's everywhere. Talk to me about the weight that you felt of 54 years. Now that it's over, now that you've won it, can you be honest about how heavy that weight was?
I'll tell you, it wasn't the 54 years. It's just never having been through it before. You know, I made it to the second round once before. This finals, you know, Mark kept telling me that fourth game will be the toughest game you'll ever have to win in your life. And it was even tougher than he told me it was going to be. It's just an amazing feeling. The 54 years, that's something I'm really happy for the fans. But this cup is, the guys worked hard for it, and it's unbelievable.
Brian, congratulations. We'll see you in the locker room.
Thanks, Al.
Brian Leach, the Conn Smythe Trophy winner. We have another star right here. It's Mike Richter. Mike, when I looked up at the clock and I saw there was a minute left, I said, Mike Richter's not off the hook yet. He's going to have to make one more big save. Did you think the same thing?
Yeah, I actually did. I hoped I would. You don't want to get it for free. And obviously every series got more difficult, and we certainly did get this cup for free. Vancouver played beautifully, and we made life hard on us on occasion, but the sign of a winner is to come back under any adversity, and we did a good job. We really did.
Mike, speaking of coming back, you know we've had an entire season and all these playoff games to talk about how you changed your career around to become what you are now, a Stanley Cup champion. And as you reflect on it, it's a very personal thing. But as you think about what you've done, what's going through your head?
I really haven't had too much of a chance to sit back and think about it. My gosh, I'm still thinking we're going to play another round, but...
No, it's over, Mike. It is. It's really over.
You know, as much as it's exciting, it's just something that you've been building for really your whole life, but after disappointing last year, we honestly said from the very, very beginning, this is what we want to do. We knew we had the players. The coaching staff's outstanding. Our management kept guys together, gave us a sense of confidence, and the players played well. So, I mean, we had a lot working for us, but it's still not easy against good teams, but it's the most satisfying feeling I've ever had in my life.
Go sip some champagne.
I will. I definitely will.
All right, Sam. We'll be in that Rangers locker room in a matter of moments, but right now, back upstairs to you.
Thanks, Al. Enjoy the celebration. Yes, the curse is over. The demons are out.
The curse is over.
No more waiting. The New York Rangers are the 1994 Stanley Cup champions. We will continue our coverage of the Rangers celebration with our post-game coverage from the locker room here at Madison Square Garden right after this.
All this traffic, you gotta get it first.
24 hours a day, get it first. Get it fast. Get it now on 1010 Win.
You give us 22 minutes, we'll give you the world.
Fuji Quick Snap Cameras at Nobody Beats the Wiz. Taking a picture doesn't get any easier. Just point and shoot.
Pick up a Fuji Quick Snap, Quick Snap Flash, or Quick Snap Waterproof, just $5.98 to $11.98. And for the brightest, most colorful prints, come to Nobody Beats the Wiz for Fuji Film and Fuji Color Processing.
Fuji Quick Snap Cameras and Fuji Film at Nobody Beats the Wiz.
Well, Dad.
A new way of seeing things.
These days, controlling your money is trickier than ever before. You've got to watch every move you make. That's why Discover Card offers the Smart Rate Program. With the Smart Rate Program, the more you purchase with your Discover Card, the lower your rate can go. Because we don't think carrying a balance should cause you to lose your balance. It pays to Discover, the card that pays you back.
Ooh. Iowa asks, does your portable CD sound this good? I hear ya!
Now available at Nobody Beats the Wiz.
Iowa, I hear ya!
Every Plymouth Neon comes with an advanced single overhead cam 16-valve engine. And its 132 high-tech horses should come in mighty handy when you're trying to coax your car onto a freeway. Say hello to Plymouth Neon, starting at $89.75. High speed, low price. Plymouth Neon, now at your Chrysler Plymouth dealer.
When I want the news, I want it fast.
24 hours a day, get it first. Get it fast. Get it now on 1010 Win.
You give us 22 minutes, we'll give you the world.
Yes, the mission is accomplished. And the time has come. The New York Rangers, in a thrilling seven-game series, in a thrilling 3-2 win. What do you think?
That just about says it all, doesn't it, Sam? 1994, Stanley Cup champions. The New York Rangers logo on it. They have represented the National Hockey League so well this season. They've deserved everything they've worked for. They've had great leadership in all areas. And this is something that is so special. It's very, very difficult to talk about how special this is.
Right now, Al Troutwig is standing by with another one of the Ranger heroes. Al, take it away.
Sam, I'm in the Rangers locker room, and we've tasted the champagne. Joey Koser is one of the big villains in that department, and Alex Kovalov is here. Alex, you've got your lucky troll.
Woo-hoo!
Are you superstitious? did he really mean something to this?
Yeah! Group?
What did he mean?
It's my big man, first man. I can say second man, first will be first Russian to win the Stanley Cup.
What does it mean to be the first Russian to win the Stanley Cup with Sergei?
I mean, Never Stanley Cup winning Russian players, but I will be first, you know. But all the season, people talking about who will be first Russian player. I did it.
Alex, you played a sensational game tonight. Did you do any special preparing for this game, or did it just happen?
Nothing did special, just play like everybody, you know, play hard, smart, that's all.
What does it feel like to taste the champagne?
Oh, great.
Alex, thanks very much.
Thanks.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
All right, we will be talking to other victorious Rangers here, Sam. It feels great. It tastes great.
Al's enjoying himself. You know, you just look at the face of Alexei Kovalov. He's 21 years old. He's from another country, another part of the world. He's come here, adapted, and been one of the great players for the New York Rangers.
And they needed him tonight. And did he ever step up and play well? He's a great kid. He loves the game. He has passion for the game. And as he was sitting there with, or standing there with Al Trautwig, and he's talking about winning the Stanley Cup, he's won a gold medal in the Olympics, but he said this is so much harder to win. And what hit me was this team will be going to Washington to meet the president. Alexei Kovalov, the Russian, with the other Russians, will be going on behalf of the New York Rangers to Washington to meet the president. It's awesome.
Al is standing by in the Rangers locker room as the guests continue to come to him at the platform. He's got Jeff Bukaboom. Al.
Sam, it's real easy to get guests in an atmosphere like this. Jeff Bukaboom wants to talk about it, although he said it's difficult to put into words. Jeff, first of all, what happened to you during this game?
Well, I hurt my knee. Nothing too serious, but serious enough that I couldn't continue. I tried, but it was just stiffened up and it's too sore. But I don't feel anything right now.
But it must have been absolutely horrible to go through for you.
Well, it could have been worse if we lost, that's for sure. My knee's going to be fine. You know, you only get so many chances at this, and you got to take advantage of it.
Jeff, enormous focus in the biggest media city in the world. I know you guys tried to downplay it, but can you describe to me what it felt like to walk into that cauldron and play the beginning of this game?
You know what? It's the best I've felt. The best I've felt as a player since game four in Vancouver. It was, I think everyone was relaxed and focused, and we played that way.
You know, the real key, though, is going to be the chant. Oh, we've got a little Eddie Olczyk. Eddie, get him.
Attaboy, Farmer!
Eddie!
Eddie, the role for you is... Yeah, go ahead. Give it to me. Oh, sure, it's empty. Eddie, I know you and I watch a lot of the games in street clothes, and I know that as an old professional, that had to kill you, but you know the role that you played for this team. How does it feel tonight?
Unbelievable. The small piece, the big piece, it doesn't matter. We're the world champions. Everybody in New York in this team, it's the greatest feeling ever.
You got a chance.
Done it without Eddie. Eddie stretched us all year.
Well, he was the player's player.
Player's player. Hey, these guys are the greatest. It's they did a heck of a job.
And you did get a chance to skate with the cup.
Unbelievable. Thank you.
Eddie, go Farmer!
All right, Sam, we'll get a few more Happy Rangers in a moment. Back to you.
What a special feeling. And here in Madison Square Garden, they are wearing the Stanley Cup T-shirts. Stanley Cup champions. And outside of Madison Square Garden, frolicking in the streets.
And they're frolicking. They're behaving themselves. They're having a great time. It's a joyous time. It's wonderful to see New Yorkers behave and have a wonderful time like this. It's a celebration, Sam. It's been building up with so many people for so long. The emotional ride of not only this series, the playoffs. It's been up. It's been down. It's been over. We're alive. We've got great leadership. And to have it come home like this is just so, so sweet.
Think of the game itself unfolding. Vancouver kept coming back. And there is the Stanley Cup. The champagne is there. Drink the champagne from the cup and enjoy it. Nick Kiprios has joined Al Trautwig in the locker room. Al?
Well, Sam, when you're one of the Black Aces, you never know if you're going to get the call. And, boy, how can you figure out you're going to get a call to play in Game 7 for the Stanley Cup?
It's unbelievable. They say timing's everything in life, and I certainly fit that bill tonight.
How did you get the news that you were going to play tonight, Nick?
I did not know till about 10 minutes before the game. Joey, right up to the line, they worked on him, and, they just made a decision, and he wasn't going, and I was in. And I know I haven't played in almost 2 months, but you got to be ready for something like this. It's a chance of a lifetime, and it's incredible. No one deserves this more than the people in this organization, from the stick boy all the way up top. It is a first-class organization, and good things happen to good people, and that's why we're champions.
You know, athletes are born to play, Nick, and yet you didn't. Yet you seem totally, totally satisfied. Can we bring this up here?
Here it is.
Is there champagne in there? There's a little bit.
Unbelievable.
It tastes great.
Unbelievable.
Yeah! Hey, New York, we'll see you at the parade. Yeah!
Yes, we will. The story continues here, Sam and JD.
Yeah! Hey, New York, here it is.
And the parade will be Friday at noon from Battery Park up to City Hall, and we will carry it for you live on MSG Network. And we certainly hope you'll join us. It will be the continuation of the celebration which has begun tonight for the New York Rangers, and a celebration they deserve, as John mentioned before, how hard it is to win, as I started to say, this game unfolding, and the pressure put on by the Vancouver Canucks. And they came so close, and they hit the post a couple of times. And the fans just inside wanting to explode, but knowing any moment their fortunes could turn. But it didn't tonight. It stayed with the Rangers, and they are the true champions of this year.
You know, this will be such a wonderful time for people to sit back in the next few days and put their feet up and maybe enjoy a nice cold beer or a cigar or a warm milk, whatever you want. But just to think about how great this is and how long it's taken and how many people have bought season tickets or fought their way into the garden to watch these great games, or people who have had season tickets handed down, grandparents to aunts and uncles, to kids. It just goes on and on and on. And I'll tell you, the players won, and so did their families and their wives. And there's so much that goes into this. It's an amazing thing.
Greg Gilbert experienced this feeling with the New York Islanders. Now he feels it with the New York Rangers. Al?
Well, yes, this is a pretty good moment for the Gilbert family. His wife came up. She's hoisting up the Stanley Cup.
Here you go, Al.
Now, Greg, your name's on this thing a couple of times already.
Yeah, twice.
But as you get a little older, things are going to happen.
You never think it's going to happen again, I'll tell you. And we got such a great group of guys here, 29 guys, 30 guys all year that work their butts off. There's no better way to be rewarded than to carry this piece of silver around.
No season is the same as another, and it's tough to compare with the years having gone by.
Yeah, no question.
Can you describe the similarities of what this team had to what your Islanders teams did?
We had a lot of experience. The guys never really lost control in the games. You know, there was times we were under pressure and we didn't really panic. And you need those kind of guys. And I learned a lot from those guys back in the Islander clubs. Boy, I'll tell you, I appreciate everything they taught me. This is kind of for them, too.
Mark Messier talked an awful lot about this speech that Mike Keenan delivered to the team yesterday. Why was it so powerful and obviously effective?
Well,
is that thing getting a little heavy?
Yeah, it was a great speech. Yeah, she's slipping out of my hands. But what Mike said yesterday is basically he still had confidence in us. And the guys still had confidence in each other. And we knew we could do the job. We just had to get back and play Ranger hockey. And we went out and did that tonight. And fortunately, we came out on top.
Greg, if you can get out of here, thanks very much and congratulations.
All right, thanks a lot.
Sam?
Thanks, Al.
I got Steve Larmer.
Oh, Steve Larmer's coming right in. Let's stay with you, Al. Go ahead.
Hey, Steve.
How are you, Al?
You haven't done this yet.
Nope, not at all. This is unbelievable. What a great feeling. All the hard work everybody puts in throughout the whole year in the playoffs, what a payday. It's incredible. My name's on it forever.
It is.
Yes, it is.
Steve, what, in your mind, what was the key element that this team had with some of the other good teams that you had and played with that just came up short?
Well, we just, the experience and the dedication and the commitment from everybody. I mean, we'd put ourselves in tight situations before, and we'd always come out on top throughout the whole season. I mean, we just had so many positive things happening to us that we could draw on to get us through another one. I mean, they're a great hockey team, and they never quit.
Talk to me about the tension. The tension for the people who are fans of this team is absolutely enormous. What was it like to be a player and be part of that, especially in this game?
Hey, it's a lot easier to play because at least you've got some kind of control on what's going to happen out in the ice. And we were in a great frame of mind for the last 2 days when we come back from Vancouver. We played 84 games to get ourselves into this position to have a seventh game. And did it pay off. It's just a great feeling. I mean, unbelievable.
Hey, Steve, 20 years from now, you're in the Hockey Hall of Fame. You walk past the Stanley Cup, and someone says, what do you think that year was like that the Rangers won the Stanley Cup? What would you say to him?
Well, the greatest year I ever had in hockey. It'd be the greatest memory in hockey. I mean, it's unbelievable. I mean, Your name's on it forever.
Steve, congratulations.
Thank you very much, Al.
Sam, it's a great thing to know that people who commit themselves can have the feeling that Steve Larmer and this team has. Back to you.
They are sipping from the Stanley Cup. And outside, they are jumping off the taxi stand as the crowd celebrates the victory of the New York Rangers. Enjoying this moment, as well they should. It's been so long coming, and the New York Rangers delivered with the victory over the Vancouver Canucks.
Yesterday, the Ranger players were being talked to. They were trying to keep their emotions in check. Craig McTavish, who played so well in this game, said, you know, they're either going to build, after Game 7, they're either going to build a podium or gallows for us. One way or the other, we're going to be raised to new heights. Well, it's nice to see a podium in
That's
there,
right.
isn't it?
And a special mention to the Ranger fans across the country. Wherever we go, whatever city we visit, there are hundreds of Ranger fans that come to see this team play, express their loyalty, watch us on the satellite dish, and to them, they share in this great, great moment. They have hung in there with their favorite team, Glenn Healy and his wife.
He hung in there all year. He was an inspiration. He spent many, many opportunities talking to Mike Richter and settling him down and instilling confidence in Mike Richter. As every once in a while, you know, that can slip away quickly, but Glenn Healy was there for this team, even though he didn't play a whole bunch.
The general manager and president of the New York Rangers shares this trophy so very much. He built this team. He's with Al right now.
Well, I don't know how many moves went into creating this Stanley Cup champion team. I don't even know if you've lost count by now, but you made the right moves, and people in this locker room just can't describe what has happened. What's going through your mind?
I'm in a trance. I think I don't know how to behave, really. To tell you the truth, it's an unbelievable feeling, and one that you hope you'll experience many times. I was lucky to experience it as a little guy with the Islanders many years ago, and ever since then, I wanted to do it for the Rangers.
Neil, is there any doubt in your mind that the draft day trade deadline moves that you made are the ones that won the cup for this team, or at least were the final piece?
Well, I think the biggest trade we ever made that won the cup for us was the Mark Messier trade 4 years ago, 3 years ago. But I wanted the deadline solidified the team, and also getting Mike Keenan in, and there were so many things. I mean, there's been so many different things, and the trades we didn't make, and lots of things. It's incredible, and the staff...
You sound hoarse. You weren't cheering or anything, were you?
I was screaming my guts out. Don't worry, Al. This is the one time I've lost all professionalism.
Minute and a half to go, you went down and sat with your wife. I think it's the first time I've ever seen you sit with her, obviously in a situation like this the first time. Tell me about that.
It's the first time I've ever sat in the seats ever for a Ranger game, but I wanted to go down and give my wife a kiss and make sure she was all right and see my mother and see all my friends and just it's their
but there
cup.
Wasn't an empty seat there. Exactly how did you find room?
Everybody was on their feet, so I was okay.
You know, Neil, so much has been said about the relationships between you and Mike Keenan and everything that's gone on, but you two went out of your way to embrace each other when this game is over. Was anything said?
No, just so we did it together and how happy we were, and we've always been that way. You know, the thing is about relationships is Mike has a different personality than I do, but that's okay. He's a coach. I'm a GM. We're not supposed to have the same personality. A lot is made out of it in the media that isn't even true. We've gotten along fine all year, but it's different than Roger Nielsen and Neil Smith, but it worked.
What about all these rumors of Mike and thoughts about you, too?
I have no idea. I don't think Mike's going anywhere. He's never indicated that to me, and he's got a long contract.
How about you?
As far as I'm concerned, this is home. I'm in my home, Madison Square Garden.
What did the champagne taste like that Mike Hudson allowed you to sip from Lord Stanley's cup a few minutes ago?
It was the sweetest nectar I've ever tasted.
Neil, congratulations. A lot
Thanks,
of people
Al.
Here who like you are very, very happy for you.
Thank you so much, Al.
Neil Smith, the president, general manager of the Rangers. This is one crowded scene. You know, this Rangers locker room is not that big. Sergei Nemchinov is here. And after the embrace, Sergei.
Hey, Al.
How you doing? Congratulations.
Good. Thank you very much.
You're full of champagne. You're full of sweat. And you with Alex now have put Russian names on the Stanley
oh, yeah.
Cup. What does that mean to you?
Well, it's new for me.
Joey, you got me great.
A little bit. I'm.
Oh, does that feel good?
I'm very proud. I'm very proud of our team. We work all year hard, and we have job done. And it's unbelievable. It's still unbelievable.
Sergei, when you call back to Russia, what kind of things will you say about this experience?
Oh.
up here, Joey?
I can say, well, my friend, we are Rangers. We win the biggest trophy in North, in NHL, as a team.
Congratulations.
The Stanley Cup, it's the biggest trophy you can win in North America and Canada as a team. And we won.
Yes, you did. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
All right, Sam, we've got Coley Campbell sipping the cup. Everyone is seeking refuge on top of our platform here. It's getting a little physical because the quarters are tight, but the celebration goes on. We'll do our best to talk to Kevin Lowe and some of the other members of this Ranger team that we haven't had a chance to talk to yet. But for now, let's go back to you.
Thanks, Al. And the fans who still linger here at the Garden to savor the moment. And outside, the fans reveling in the glory of the New York Rangers. How do you like that, traveling, asking Joey Costa to pour some champagne on his head?
I wish I was there.
Oh. We will stay with you. The post-game festivities continue on the night, June 14th, 1994, that the New York Rangers won the Stanley Cup.
To soothe athlete's foot, to relieve the burning, the itching, Desinex does it. But to cure athlete's foot, to kill the fungus that causes it, Desinex does it. Only Desinex has UDA, proven to both soothe the itching and